Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Banging Donuts with Mr. Christopher. I am Vinny Bag of Donuts.
I'm Bangs Michael. I'm Mr. Christopher.
This week's show, we are covering the Nintendo Switch conference. Last 24 hours have been pretty crazy. We had the conference in Japan last night around 11 p.m. Eastern, 8 Pacific, all in between. Then this morning about 9:30, 6:30 Pacific, we had the Treehouse event that was North American. A lot of things to cover. A lot of things happened. We saw a whole new aspect of the Switch. Well, we saw more than what we saw originally. You could argue we still didn't see enough for a console that is coming out in a month and a half, but we saw more. Before we even talk about the Switch itself, I do want to bring up like this. As far as presentations go, straight up presentations, this may have been, I don't want to start off negative right out the gate, but this might have been the worst presentation I have ever
Oh
seen.
God,
Video
the
games or
Japanese.
not. Yeah, it was
Yeah,
just
it was horrible.
bad. It was two screens, a couple guys speaking Japanese, which is fine. It was in Japan. The translator was
Yeah.
shit. A lot
All
of
the
finger
translator was
snapping.
so funny.
Yeah,
Well,
a lot of finger
there was
snapping.
multiple translators. So every person had their own translator. So there was that one
Yeah.
translator for whatever his name, Suda 51. The
Don't
guy's got
know.
a fucking number in his name. That guy's translator was awful.
But was it
It was
translator's fault or was this guy
funny.
stuttering like a motherfucker the entire time? We don't know.
Well, from what I read, it was a combination of things. Most of the speakers had a script, so the translators were able to work off a script partially. Apparently Suda 51 did not have a script, and apparently he also has a very specific dialect, and the translator was like having on the fly to make sure that he was translating certain words correctly.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
That makes sense. It was a video, mostly a video behind. I'm just talking presentation alone. It
Yeah.
was pretty poor for a 20.
It was go
I
ahead.
don't know. No,
It's interesting. It's interesting what Japan sees as a launch conference compared to the Treehouse event this morning. I mean, they're night and day presentations. It's very interesting to me what in Japan they see as a exciting quality, launch.
You know what's funny? This launch was it was the presentation was something I'd expect maybe at like an E3 last year, not
Yeah.
when you're releasing your console a month and a half away.
Right. Yeah, it was pretty rough. To
It's
say
only
the
a month
least.
and a half, huh?
Yeah.
Wow,
Yeah.
it's coming up
It's like
quick.
48
Yeah,
days or something like that.
March 3rd, right? So,
Yeah.
jeez, man.
Yeah.
I wonder why they're doing pre-releases and I mean,
Pre-orders.
what is it? Yeah, pre-orders and things like that.
Yeah.
Now, is there a limit on the pre-orders?
Yes, quantities are limited. Yeah,
Wow.
I'm sure it's one per customer. I honestly I didn't even look because I won't be pre-ordering, but
Yeah. I didn't even check that out actually.
I don't know that it's one per customer. I don't know, but I've seen a lot of pictures from taken at GameStop. Like, apparently GameStop learned their lesson from the Classic. So they've been posting a flyer in their window, pre-orders now. This is how many units we're gonna get. And the number is less than 50 on every single one.
Ugh. Yeah, typical Nintendo.
So
Why sell as much as possible at launch, right? You only knew this was coming out how long?
yeah, I mean, I guess the scarcity raises demand, which increases interest. I suppose if they don't overdevelop hardware, if the thing bombs, they didn't lose a fuck ton of money on hardware, but
It still won't be enough for probably what it will sell. It's
it
just
probably
typical.
yeah, it probably won't. But
I can't wait to see what the secondary market looks like.
at the same
Oh,
time,
jeez.
if they don't have, let's be honest, they don't have the strongest software lineup at launch, so
Oh. You gotta
but
see
they
how
don't.
fast it's generating out too. Like if it's like, okay, we sold out initial, but next month we'll be back, having more. Like
Yeah.
they fucked up with the NES Classic. NES Classic, it was so hard to come. Now I don't even want it. Like I don't give a fuck about it. Like I couldn't care less about
Yeah.
having it. And that
Yeah.
is exactly what I thought was gonna happen. I'm sure a lot of people feel the same way I do.
Yeah.
Yeah, they should have front loaded that thing because yeah, just like you said, who wants it now? I mean, maybe it's after Christmas. Everyone's got what they
It's
want.
so badass, though. I mean, it's so
Yeah. No,
badass. Look
it
at this
looks
fucking
cool.
thing.
It
It's so
looks cool.
awesome.
I don't want it. I was just
I know.
playing, I was just on my stream,
I have not played it in a month, but it's so cool.
we were doing SNES and NES games, my stream the other day, and I had more than 30 for that
Yeah.
little thing. But anyway, let's not get sidetracked. So one of the big things they announced right off the gate was the price. $299.99. Yep. How do we feel about that price?
Too expensive.
Really?
Too expensive.
It's a terrible launch price.
What was the launch price for the Wii?
$199.
No, launch price. Oh, the Wii. The Wii, yeah. Yeah, the Wii.
The Wii, yeah. The first Wii. The original Wii was $199. $199 has been the launch price, I think, starting with the Super Nintendo. Super Nintendo 64, GameCube. No, GameCube was $250, but it came down very quickly. And then,
well,
you know what?
Forget, we might have
been
$250
as well.
I think the Wii was $250.
It might have been $250, but again, it came down very quickly.
But you also got to, you know, adjust for inflation with those older ones, though. You got to watch out. You can't exactly say $199.
Well, adjusted for inflation, $199 is a hell of a lot more today.
Yeah.
But just looking at the marketplace, I just had this conversation with my wife. You can get now an Xbox One for $250 with games.
I'm 100%. That's one of my biggest problems. $299, way too much. $250 would have been fine. And you got to look at it more as it's not $300 that they're charging. You got to look, what are you getting for that $300?
Right.
So, like Banks just said, you can get a brand new Xbox One with a game for $250.
At least, if not two or three.
And a brand new PS3 is $300 with a game bundled in. PS4, you're right. But, and you can also say, hey, but those systems are 4 years old. Yeah, but look at what you're getting with it. Look at the you're paying for the power and the other things. You're not, you know.
Yeah, they have a huge game library and. Yeah. Those games are now, you know, shit. I bought my PS4 2 years ago, and I've rarely paid more than $40 for a game because they're all discounted so aggressively by now.
So you thought that was
the quality?
Yeah, you thought that was.
I was gonna say that the quality of all these old games, like the PS4 games and the Xbox 360 game, at the moment they're still like holding up.
Oh yeah. We're reaching a point. On the graphics side of things, we're reaching a point where, VR aside, we're hitting that ceiling, I think, of how far we can take it. So they're not going to get that much better.
You got to ask yourself, at $299.99, what are they? Is it just a money grab? Because where is that? Where, like, how expensive is the Joy-Con technology? Because you know it's not in internal memory. It's not in... No.
Well, internal memory is cheap anyway.
Well, it's not in battery. It's not in like a high graphics card. So where's that money? Like, you want to charge $299. Show me what is costing $299. Is it the Joy-Con controllers?
I mean, it's the tablet. It's the screen. It's the tablet.
Screen. Okay.
Yeah.
And I want to get into this. Like, it's not just $299, guys. Let's add it all up.
With the games and the pro controller and everything else.
Let's add it up real quick. Because I did this math a little bit earlier. Okay, say you buy the system, $299.99. I got it right here. $299.99. Okay. Right, boys?
Yep.
Well, that's the system. This is all going to be no tax. Let's buy a game. Let's buy Zelda. $60.
We're assuming it's $60.
We're assuming
it's
$60.
I heard it might be
$65
or
$70. Which I didn't want to get into. Okay, so we're up to $360, right?
Mm-hmm.
Let's say, well, we only got one controller. Let's buy the pro controller.
Okay.
$70.
Is that thing $70?
$70 they are for a pro controller. We're up to $429.
Yep.
Okay. Yep. So it comes with 32 gigabytes internal memory. Not enough. You can say, oh, Nintendo, their games are small. But it already got confirmed Legend of Zelda is going to take up 40% of that internal memory.
They said this morning on the Treehouse thing. Well, they said two things. One, and this is like these are the only, probably the only positives I had to say about the system. The games aren't going to install. You're just going to be save files and digital downloads. So there's not
Zelda.
Gonna be any,
what?
Zelda.
That's
installs.
What they said.
Zelda installs. I just read the thing. It's all over the thing. People made a big deal about it. Zelda's taking up 40% of the memory because it's a 12 point gigabyte download.
Okay. Well, then the second point of that is that it uses generic SD cards. And this morning they put a 256 gig in there. So we know it takes at least that.
Yeah.
So.
No, the good thing is it's endless memory, really.
Right.
But we're gonna want to upgrade the memory, right? You know, 32 gigabytes. If Zelda's gonna take up 12, we're gonna upgrade it. Let's say we're gonna put in 250, right? Mm-hmm. Now, you know, those things change cost based on how much, you know, which, who's making it, and all that stuff. But let's just generically say, what, $50?
$250? On the high end, but sure.
On the high, okay, let's, all right, well, let's call it 40. Let's add $40.
Sure. Okay. So what are we at, 470?
470.
Plus tax, now, title, and licensing.
Plus tax, title, and licenses. Now, say you don't want to get the Pro Controller, right? Say, okay, $70. I'm like, let's get another set of Joy-Cons.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
How much do those run you?
$80.
$80.
Yes.
$80. So let's add $10 because we're going to get those. And wait, those don't come with the grip and the attachment on top.
Oh, when they
you
don't?
Buy, nope. You have to buy the attachment. How much do those go? Those go for $7.99 a piece. We're going to need two of them. $7.99. So
wait,
you want...
What's the $7.99?
The wrist strap with the makes
with the top. It makes it a little bit thicker.
It says Joy-Con L, Joy-Con... Oh, if you buy it... If you buy the Joy-Con with the thing that you're talking about, it costs $50.
No, the little thing, the system itself is going to come with those straps. If you were to buy a set of Joy-Cons separately, it doesn't come with that attachment with the wrist straps. You have to buy that separate. Those come separate. And they're $7.99.
So you get it. Yeah, you get a set with the system, but extras are separate.
Okay.
Apparently.
I'm looking at the website, and it says Joy-Con L, Joy-Con R. Mm-hmm. It's $50. Add more players to compatible games with left or right Joy-Con controller.
Oh no! If you separately. Buy them, if you buy them separately, they're $50. That's left or right. Bundled together, they're $80, which makes no sense. If I want a left or right, shouldn't it cost $40, not $50?
Oh.
Yeah, if you buy them separately, if you need just the left or just the right, it's $50.
Together, so you just buy 80. One, it's $50.
What? That's
ridiculous. 70 for the Pro Controller. Yeah, 80 for the left and right. Well, I think you're wrong, Vinny, because I'm looking at the box for the extra Joy-Con controllers, and the box shows the wrist strap on it.
Okay, no problem. Let's take that. We'll take that $15 right off. Just because there's some confusion, we'll take that off. So basically, if we're buying the system, we're getting a game, obviously. We want to upgrade the memory, and we want to play with friends. Were we just going to play by ourselves the entire time? So we're going to get another controller. I always bought another controller when I get a new system.
Yeah, of course.
$480.97 before tax.
Yeah.
That's how much.
And you only have one game.
One game. That's how much a Nintendo Switch is going to cost you.
Yeah.
So it's coming with the one game. Like it's going
no,
to
it's not bundled
with
it. No.
We built it.
We added a game.
We put Zelda in.
We
put
our own bundle. Okay.
Yeah, we put Zelda in, yeah.
So it doesn't come with the game at $299, which
jeez, man.
How do you not launch at $299 with the hardware you have? I'm not saying, the PlayStation launched at $399 or whatever, it didn't come with the game. You look at the hardware you're getting. So the hardware
plays Blu-rays, it has streaming, it has the PlayStation and the Xbox are positioning themselves as living room, you know, set top boxes, not as just gaming consoles.
And I'm taking PC, we're talking consoles. I'm not touching on PC, you know, all that stuff get out of there.
No.
I'm talking just purely the three consoles. So at $299, you're not that hardware is where this is my biggest problem with the whole Twitch thing. I know we're getting ahead a little bit. It's not the equipment, it's not the system itself. It's Nintendo. Seems like they're money grabbing. With a lot of extra things. $80 for Joy-Con sticks? $70 for a Pro controller?
Well,
Is that MSRP, though?
Yeah, it is MSRP. But Nintendo's notorious for not being cheaper than MSRP. I imagine, there is, it sounds like, a lot of technology. Just playing devil's advocate because I'm not on board. But it sounds like there's a lot of technology in the Joy-Cons. The yen isn't as strong against the dollar as it typically has been in the past, or the yen. You've got a lot of retail partners who got fucked on the Wii U. Maybe their margins are a little bit higher this time around, you know, so it's probably a lot of things, but it's not competitive. The pricing isn't competitive. If they couldn't be at a competitive price, then they should have gone a different direction.
Yeah. Well, that's what it's, because the problem is they're still going to make money, because let's be honest, for the most part, for some whatever reason, call it nostalgia or whatever, Nintendo fans have a blind fucking eye when it comes to the big N. Like, they could do no wrong. If you look, I got into an argument today with one of my friends because half their lineup is nostalgia grabbing shit. Yeah. Where's the new, give me new IPs. Stop living 20 years ago. And his argument was, nostalgia sells consoles. That's true.
But it's worse this generation with Nintendo.
Nostalgia sells a lot of things. When, as consumers, are we going to stop relying on nostalgia? Like, are we going to stop buying into nostalgia and ask companies, not just Nintendo, to better their self? Because, let's be honest, scientifically speaking, or psychologically speaking, nostalgia, it's never really as good as we remember it better than it was.
Yeah.
Right. Always. Well,
and it's an expiring concept, because if you don't develop new products, you won't have new nostalgia. So the next generation, you won't have something 30 years from now to go back on. But let's talk about that for a second, because that was one of my biggest pet peeves about the Treehouse presentation today, when they showed like four times as many games as they showed yesterday at the Japanese event. Like, three of their marquee games were SNES games.
Yeah.
Bottom line, it was a Street Fighter II upgrade,
great of an upgrade, in my opinion.
But yeah, exactly. I mean, I'm cool with that. I get it. It's your 30th anniversary of Street Fighter. You're gonna put out a new, new update to it. Street Fighter II Turbo, I think everybody owned that on SNES. That was the first game I bought with my own money for the Super Nintendo. I get it. I'm in. I'm down. But as a marquee title for your launch event, that is weak sauce. And then they called it at the Japanese event, I'm checking my notes, they called it a Square Enix game, but they showed the game this morning at the event, and it was called something 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 Project Octopath, and it's Final Fantasy 3 for the SNES.
Yeah,
it's, they call them roguelike. It's just a typical turn-based RPG, but it looks like it was made for Super Nintendo. I'm cool with that. I love those games. Cool. But it's not a marquee launch title for 2017. No.
Did you see the rumored the price for that Street Fighter 2?
No.
$40.
Street Fighter 5 came out a year ago. They're not even putting that on the system, as far as I know. They're doing Street Fighter 2 Ultra Final something something Electric Boogaloo. I mean, listen, I'm the Nintendo fanboy of the show. I love Nintendo. I've said time and time again that, Nintendo has never done me wrong, and that's true. But this system launch is so uninspiring. I think
there's no games.
There's no games, number one. Number two, I feel like from a hardware perspective, I feel like they look at the Wii U and said, "Oh, this system failed. The original Wii was a huge success. So let's do that again." And so there's all these fucking motion controls that are coming back.
I don't want motion controls.
I don't want it either. I mean, it's fine. I've had motion controls that were used well. You know, the Wii Motion Plus game, which was just a bunch of mini games, was actually one of the most fun games on the Wii.
Sure.
So it can be done. But also, how many games crammed motion controls in for no reason? Crammed the sensor bar in for no reason, where it didn't need to be there, put it in because they could, not because they should. And so that Japanese presentation, and everything's about milking a fucking cow.
Yeah.
Well, let me ask you,
you're going backwards to, again, it was a fad. Let's just be honest about it. The popularity of the Wii was a fad. It was a huge fad. I credit Nintendo all day long for taking a risk, for pushing the industry forward and pushing the envelope and taking risks, but they're not taking risks with this system. This system is a flashback to some old shit.
The Wii U was not the
you
Wii
don't
U.
get
the,
to talk, Mr. Wii, Christopher.
Sorry. Let me just say this one thing. The Wii was a success, but it wasn't at the same time. It was success as far as numbers. It was great out the gate, got new people into gaming, but it didn't hold longevity. At the end of the day, they didn't win the last gen console wars when it comes to sales numbers, because they stopped selling, and then PS3 and Xbox 360 just blew past it. Well, 360 was up there too, but so it was gimmicky. People got tired of it, which is the same thing with this one. I think don't get, when you play for the first time, it's probably going to be fun. You know, it's fun. Sure. Look at that 2-1 Switch. I'm sure that's going to be fun. There's going to be fun little games on that.
Right. But are you playing that? Age well.
No. Are you playing that for 3 months? You playing that for more than a week?
No.
It's like a Rock Band. You're bringing it out when there's people over.
Who's playing those old Wii games? The bowling and the boxing and all that. And who's still playing those? Versus who's still playing,
I feel like you're judging me right now, Mr. Kristopher, and I don't appreciate it.
You do not play those games.
You know what? The boxing one's fun. I'm not gonna lie. The boxing one
was fun. That was my favorite one. Yeah. And the tennis one was all right too.
Yeah.
Oh, I rocked the shit out of bowling.
Yeah, but it's like it's not something that ages well. It's not gonna be something you're playing in 10 years. You're gonna be like, what is this? This doesn't even, you know.
Well, it's not even that. It'll be a been there, done that. Like, yeah, you'll probably still think well of it. You'll go, oh yeah, it's so much fun. I'm not putting it in right now. I've been there, done that.
No, it's cool. And Nintendo deserves all the credit in the world. Like you said, they pushed that envelope. They started that fad, that hype. But you're exactly right. It was a fad. Like it just, people moved on. People wanted. You know,
I was going to say it's a lot like, you know, when they redid the Star Wars movies, the original trilogy, and they put all this fucking special effects in there. But you look at it now when they're, I don't know, 10, 15 years old now. I don't even remember. The CGI looks horrible.
They would have been better leaving it.
Yeah, exactly. So, you know, you go back to the Wii and, you know, now, okay, you know, the Switch is going to have so much better motion controls. You look back at the Wii, it's like archaic. And, you know, what is it going to be like in 10 years from now? I don't think people are going to be going back to the Switch trying to, you know, milk cows and stuff.
I think Nintendo, I think Nintendo consoles in general age better than their competitors because they usually do hold back a little bit graphically. So they do a little more animated style, and that just typically doesn't look bad over time. You know, the Disney vault, they keep putting out the same classic Disney movies, you know, year after year after year, because they don't degrade. It's still a hand-drawn picture or computer animated picture. And I think Nintendo,
no, they age better because when they come out, they're already 10 years behind.
I think, you know, if they get the software out over the lifespan of the console, we might think differently about it, but it's good. They got an uphill battle right now. If I'm not excited to go buy it day one, you have an uphill battle.
Since we're on games, we talked about some games, just mentioned that. Let's go over some of the games that showed. Of course, they ended with Zelda. Zelda's going to be Zelda. We know what we're getting with that. For me, it's not a system seller, but it will be for a lot of people. I think it looked good. It looked Zelda open world. It looked fine. That's their big game. That's what they're banking on. And I think that's a strong showing. Agreed?
Zelda was strong. But that game's also going to be on the Wii U.
Yes, yeah, exactly. I'm just talking about the showing itself of the game. Yeah, but you're right. You're right. Like, if I want to play it that bad, I'm going to go Wii U. Mm-hmm. Typical.
Yeah, $300
Well, the graphics they've shown for the Switch don't look markedly better than the Wii U. So as far as this one game, it's probably not even going to matter. If you already own a Wii U, I don't think Zelda Breath of the Wild is a console mover.
Well, I mean, you're getting to the point where, you know, technology is getting so good, but you're not going to have a huge difference in how the games look, like from the Nintendo to the Super Nintendo. It's, you know, night and day. But you're going from the Wii U to the Switch. How much better are the graphics going to be? I mean,
they could be a lot better because they're behind to begin with. But yeah, I understand your point.
Yeah. With your point. Yeah. But okay. So Zelda's going to be Zelda. Mario Kart 8 Deluxe.
Yeah.
It's a port pretty much. Comes out a month later. That's a good timing. It could have been. I don't know why they just don't launch with it. Does it really need an extra month?
I'm sure their thought process is they don't want to cannibalize the sales of other games, but you don't have that many games coming out, so you could have just rolled with it.
It's Mario 8 Deluxe. You're getting a revamped battle mode, which I watched them play today. I don't like that. Some of the tracks looked awesome. The time limit. I hope that's in settings. It was 3 minutes, 5 balloons. Yeah. Half the time, no one got knocked out for 3 out of the 4 courses they played.
Yeah.
don't want to play battle mode and it's impossible to fucking knock someone out. Unless they were doing 3 minutes. Yeah, unless they were doing 3 minutes, that's in settings. Unless they were doing it so they could show a couple maps.
Yeah, fine. I mean, you should be able to turn it off. The time.
I would imagine. I mean, that's been a staple of Mario Kart from the beginning. So, from 64 when they had a battle mode. But
you get all the DLC from the Wii U version, plus two new racers, King Boo and the Squid Fuckers.
Yeah, Splatoon.
Two new cars. Two new squid of all those things. And now they have that feature where you can carry two items, like the what was it?
Double. No, did they? I was waiting to see that this morning. I didn't see it.
No, that was there. They have that. You can pick up two items. Now you can bank an item. But you know what? I'm not super excited about this because I got on Mario. It's my fault. I got on Mario Maker so late. I mean, not Mario Maker. Mario Kart. Mario Kart so late. we just started playing that a couple months ago around here. For me anyway. So I had all the DLC, so it's not like, I don't know. It's okay. It's a nice little port. I think it's needed. You need Mario Kart.
If you skip the Wii U, you absolutely have to get... If you skip the Wii U and you're getting the Switch, you 100% need to get Mario Kart 8 Deluxe.
Yeah.
Sure. 100%. It's a fantastic game.
Do we agree on a 60-point launch? Is that fine? Is it worth... Because you're only getting X amount of new features, but you're getting all $60? The DLC. It's a $60 launch point.
You're getting a couple years old. Yeah, I mean, you're getting the DLC. So if you bought the DLC as a package, I think it was like $12, $15. So you could probably get away with $60. I think they're probably banking on the fact that not many people are going to. If they already own it, they're probably not going to buy it again. So they're really targeting people that didn't buy the Wii U, of which there are lots. So they're probably good at $60 from a business standpoint. I would like it to see it more around 40, but I think 40 would be nice. I don't hate that price. Yeah, I don't hate that price, but a 40 would have been better.
40 would have been nice. Yeah. Because, they release, say, like...
I would
like,
rebuy it at 40.
Yeah, say, like, Fallout 4. No, I'm just throwing an example. Say a Fallout 4 gets a Game of the Year, comes with all the DLC. You get a lot. A lot of games come out, Game of the Year, the DLC. It's usually not 60. It's usually around 40 to 50.
Yeah, and it usually drops down to 20 real quick.
Yeah.
Yeah.
After a couple of months.
So what about the... Okay, so they have a new IP. Oh, Chris, did you want to say anything about Kart?
No, it's just... It feels rehashed. It feels like... How long are you going to play it before you're like, oh, this is... You know, if it's 80% like, the Mario Kart 8, it's like, eh...
Yeah, okay.
Let's just say it's not blowing my mind.
We played Mario.
We all have Mario Kart 8.
Yeah, and we played it late in its cycle too. I think they're targeting people who bought it originally, played it for a while, but then they haven't played it for a year. And they're getting the Switch. And my problem this is another one of my points with fucking the Nintendo and the nostalgia thing. Mario Kart's a good example. As much as I love Mario Kart, Mario Kart 8 is a fantastic fucking game. Mm-hmm. Most of those tracks are just remade, rehashed, living off nostalgia.
Yeah.
Make new fucking tracks, Nintendo. It's not fucking hard to make a new track.
Well, they need new IP to base it off of.
Good point.
Now there's some announcement about the old Mario Karts that maybe we'll get to later, or I don't know if we want to tackle now, involved with the online gaming.
Well,
yeah,
I'm sure they might have
DLC, but that's
if we're gonna
guess.
Before the online thing, let's continue with the games that they showed. New IP, the one new IP that was big that they fucking killed to death is this game.
The Arms.
At
this point, I'm so sick of that fucking game. I've never played it.
I love the
very beginning where they have the girl, the school girl coming out in a little.
The video
dress.
Was funny. Yeah, the Japanese. Yeah. But they played Arms for like 45 minutes this morning on the Treehouse event.
Oh, they did?
Just straight. It was just two guys fucking playing the game, and I'm like, I get it. I've seen it. Their arms spring out. Okay.
Is it just a fighting game, one versus one? There's only five players, five characters.
Yeah, they showed five players. I mean, presumably there's going to be some sort of story mode and there's some sort of unlock. I'm sure there's unlockable characters. I'm sure there's more than five. You would hope.
Basically,
it's a fighting game.
It's a game to use the Joy-Cons to make people use them to show them off and all that good stuff.
Yeah. I will say this, as much as I look at that game and I go, okay, yeah, it's kind of cool, it looks kind of fun, but it's also not much to it. I feel the same way about Splatoon, and Splatoon was a surprise hit for Nintendo. I never played Splatoon either, but it was a huge game. Like there's MLG, you know, tournaments for Splatoon. I see that potential in ARMS. So they might be sitting on a hit with ARMS, but I'm already sick of seeing it.
Yeah, it looks like it could be fun playing a little bit. It could probably be addicting when you're playing it. It's one of those games that's probably not, it's not fun to watch. I don't want to watch two people play it.
Right.
When you're playing, right. It's probably fun as all hell.
It's probably huge fun to play, yeah.
$60 price tag, it's fine. Normal game price.
Yeah,
that's fine. With that.
It seems like one of those games that should have been included.
Would have been a good game to bundle.
I thought the 1-2 Switch game was bundled when they talked about it.
It sounds like it should be. No.
It's not bundled. No, there are no bundled games.
My goodness.
That 2-1 Switch should be bundled. That would make it perfect sense.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, like, those initial games with the Wii, like with the boxing and all that bundled?
Wii Sports came bundled. The Wii U did not come with a game.
Oh.
So Nintendo came, SNES came, Game Boy came with a game, 64 did not, GameCube did not, Wii did, Wii U did not. That's been the life cycle. And now Switch does not.
So ARMS isn't a launch title, though. Shit, I fucked that up. It is Spring.
Oh, really? I thought it was a launch title. I had it written down as a launch title.
Mine says quarter two to 2016. So, yeah, that would be Spring.
Okay, so Spring, yeah. Oh, okay. Well, there you go. It's not even a launch title.
No, but Spring could be April.
It's going to be shortly after.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, Mario Kart 8 comes out like March 31st. So it's not a launch title, but it's coming out almost.
It's beginning April, first week April.
Yeah.
Okay, so Splatoon 2, we just touched on. I never played Splatoon. It was a big hit. From what I heard, it's more of the same.
Yeah, I know people are excited for it. The people that like Splatoon are excited for it.
So I'm expecting it's probably good things. So,
yeah,
I was gonna say it's probably a good Twitch game, right? I mean,
Splatoon, it is. I've watched it played, and it's just like Mario Kart. They get all their viewers in, and it is kind of fun to watch because it's crazy. It's like Mario Kart. It's just crazy, wild nonsense until somebody wins. But that's all I know about it.
Well, you know, speaking of Twitch, are there any games that you guys are looking forward to playing on Twitch?
For the Switch?
I don't think I'm getting one for a while, so...
Mario Odyssey is probably the only thing.
Yeah, I don't think I'd do Zelda. I'd do an updated Mario Kart runs.
Yeah, of course.
No.
Yeah, I mean... No.
It makes me wonder, do they even acknowledge that something like Twitch exists? I mean,
well, they must, because they did both of their events on Twitch on their official Twitch channel. So according to Vinny, they flew Witwix out to do the damn presentation. So obviously they're familiar with Twitch, but the thing is that Twitch is such an American business. I mean, it's worldwide, but it's not. It's like 90% US based. Japan is literally on its own island, and they live in their own little bubble. You know, people accuse America of being in its bubble. Japan is probably worse as far as living in the bubble. So from a development standpoint, I don't think Nintendo of Japan is giving two shits about Twitch.
I'm surprised for fucking $2.99 they couldn't put a fucking thing in there that lets me stream straight through Twitch like fucking PlayStation Xbox does.
Well, they've got that online service coming, so let's see what happens. But because they do have the button that lets you take
screenshots,
and it's going to let you do video in the future.
Video. Yeah, that's a software.
Right? Huh?
More like clips, right? I would.
Yeah, supposed to be clips, but that's a software issue. So that is something that theoretically could exist in the future, regardless of what it does today.
Yeah. Well,
you're right. It's not going to happen because there's no camera and there's all these other problems. No. But it is theoretically possible.
We stream through capture cards anyway. It's not that big of a deal for us. But all right, let's. I like doing this with the games. There wasn't a lot of them, so let's just go through a couple of them real quick.
Yeah, that's true. Like,
Minecraft's coming. That's good. You kind of expect that. It's on every fucking console and system you can think of. It fits Nintendo. The weird thing is, I doubt this. There's no way this is the price, because it's like a $20 game. Best Buy has it for $60. But it's a to be announced when it's released, so that's probably going to change, because there's no way they're going to charge $60.
You hope not.
I hope not, but knowing Nintendo, you never fucking know. 1-2 Switch, we talked about.
Yep.
I don't know. It's like every other. It's Nintendo Land or whatever. It's
yeah.
It
show, it's a bunch of mini games.
Bunch of mini games makes you use the Joy-Con controller. That's basically all it is. It looked cool. That dueling, yeah. Like, I don't know if I'll ever play it. The dueling thing looks fucking stupid. You don't have to look at the screen. You fucking jerk off a cow. That should be like a $20 game. They have it listed at GameStop for $50, Target for $60.
Best it should be bundled. 60. It should be bundled.
That should have been a bundle
That's
game.
That's not a real 100% game.
100% should have been a bundle game. Just like the Wii was bundled with Wii Sports. It's the same fucking thing.
Yeah.
Odyssey. We saw Mario Odyssey. This is their big announcement. I don't know. My biggest thing, Odyssey, it says fucking holiday 2017.
Yeah.
How do you not have a Mario game within almost a year of your new system launch?
Yeah. Because of Zelda. Because Zelda got pushed back to launch, and they don't want in their ridiculous mind, they don't want to cannibalize the sale of Zelda with Mario and vice versa. So they're separating their two franchises. Because it is. Mario and Zelda are Nintendo's franchises. Donkey Kong, fuck it. Metroid, fuck it. It's Mario and it's Zelda. That's number one and number two. And on any given day, they could switch places. And so if Zelda's going to be a launch title, you're pushing Mario out because you don't want them competing.
Push it's it out stupid. 3 months.
You'd sell them both on day one. You would sell both games on day one because those are going to be the two must-have. For anybody that's going to buy a Switch, those are going to be the two must-have games. But that's not the way. I mean, I'm just speaking of the way Nintendo thinks and the way business works. That's why they pushed it out. It's going to be a must-have holiday game. And you know what? It's going to move consoles for Christmas.
It 100% will. No, I get that. I wish they would have had some type of merit. Maybe they'll have some ports. Maybe a Sunshine or maybe...
fuck that game.
Well, whatever. Because how could you play a whole year of Mario?
Fast my hatred.
How could you play a whole year of Nintendo games and Mario's only appearance is cart? So that's, you know. But okay, yeah. So we saw the Odyssey. Again, summer. Holiday. I'm sorry.
Christmas. Yeah.
What? And it looked a lot. I should have watched the trailer a little bit more. It looked like it was all over the fucking place. They're going back to the 3D realms, different realms, more N64 style. There was a real world where Mario was in like the real world.
It takes place. Yeah. Parts of the game take place in the real world,
which leads me to my theory that I've been saying for fucking ever on Mario. What Mario really is, he's just some fucking shitty broken down plumber. He fucking is addicted to fucking acid and shrooms.
Mushrooms.
Yeah, mushrooms. Fucking Peach is just a local fucking whore stripper from down the street. They get together. They fucking do acid. They chip balls.
GTA 6, Mushroom Kingdom.
Yeah, and they just completely mind trip. The Mushroom Kingdom is just a fucking mind trip for Mario and whore, who's just fucking needle hanging
Mario
out of the arm.
Mario and whore.
Mario
she doesn't
and whore.
Even have a name.
Peach, bitch, her peach, bitch, whore. Peach, bitch.
Yeah, just a needle hanging out of the arm. Passed out on the couch. Their dog's name is fucking Koopa or some bullshit. And Mario's boss is Bowser. That's fucking this. So I'm finally getting the game of my dreams.
You know, there is a Mario mod for GTA 5.
I did see that. There's one for Vice City, too.
Oh, is there? Maybe that's what it is. Maybe it's Vice City. I don't know.
Horror and horror.
But, we didn't see enough
funny,
of it.
There's... There's no announcement for Smash, which is one of the big games.
That's not unusual, though. The Why? Smash, for Smash, for some reason, every new system, everyone's like, there's got to be a Smash. And they don't talk about it until like the day before it's hitting the shelves. They do it every fucking generation.
Interesting.
I don't know why, but that's because I remember on the Wii, by the time I bought my Wii, Smash was out. But I remember going, I want two things. I want Smash and I want Mario Kart. And, I mean, it took a while for those two games to hit the system. So by the time I bought my Wii, I guess I was a late adopter to the Wii as well, because it was down to like 200, 150, something like that when I bought it.
You call yourself a fanboy, but really, are you?
I guess maybe I'm not. Because I also think about the 64, and I had to sell all my Nintendo and SNES stuff to afford to buy the 64, and it had been out a while as well.
Well, listen, you gotta go when you have the money, man.
Yeah.
Let's just bang through some of these games. Let's bang through them real quick. So there's a couple of ones that we don't give a fuck. Fire Emblem Warriors, no idea what that is.
It's
I
a
saw
huge
it another day.
franchise. It's a huge franchise. It's going to sell a fuck ton of copies in Japan and Europe. It'll do well here, but it's not going to
I've
move the
never heard
needle.
of it. Never heard of it. Okay.
It's a long-standing Japanese franchise. It's very popular,
Wow.
especially on mobile. It's mostly a mobile game. Or not mobile, sorry, handheld. But yeah, it's a
Yeah, I
huge
was going to
franchise.
say, Nintendo doesn't do mobile.
Yeah, sorry, handheld.
Xenoblade Chronicles 2, the first one I feel
Yep.
like just came out not too long ago.
Yeah, I have
I
it.
didn't
It's still
play
in the
it.
shrink wrap. I paid $10
Yeah,
for it
I
on
didn't play
sale.
it. It had mixed reviews, I heard. I don't know. It's like open world. It was c supposed to be their version of Final Fantasy that hasn't been around
Yeah.
for a while
Well,
on console.
same thing. Xenoblade is an anime. It's huge in Japan. It's pretty big in Europe, and it does okay in the US. It's the
Yeah, I'm
same.
sure.
It's just like, yeah, it's like Fire Emblem.
Sure, it does five. The ultimate fucking dog and pony show is Elder Scrolls Skyrim, because you are not
Yeah.
playing Skyrim on Nintendo, even if it's a special edition, which I was wondering. Imagine they just ported the original Skyrim game that came out in 2011 because they could finally have the hardware to play that.
Right.
It is a special edition, but no one in the right mind is playing Skyrim on the Nintendo. You're playing it PC,
Yeah,
Xbox,
if you wanted to
PlayStation.
play it,
You're,
you've already played
yeah,
it.
if you want to
Well,
play, you
hold on
already
a
play.
second. I have never played Skyrim,
Don't
so
get
I
on
might act.
it. Don't. The
Why?
only reason why I'll tell you
Because
not
it's
to.
like $20 on PlayStation, and it was on the Steam sale for less than that. If you were gonna
No,
play it, you the
that
opportunity was to
well,
play it.
it's not about pricing at all, because the special edition just came out. It's
Okay.
about, it's still a special edition, brand new. It's the there's no way in hell it's graphically and horsepower is going to keep up on the Nintendo Switch as it would with on PC, PS4, Xbox, because the Switch they're saying is not even as powerful, or maybe just as powerful as the PlayStation 3, which Skyrim came out on already.
What? Really? That's interesting.
I
As
skipped the
horsepower goes,
PS3, so I don't know.
as far as horsepower goes, all I'm saying is
Yeah.
don't, if you're out there, don't play Skyrim on Switch. Nothing gets, it's just to get the full experience of Skyrim, the load screens are going to be fucking take forever. I can guarantee that on
Yeah.
the Switch. That's a huge fucking open world. Huge.
Just
Right.
logically, that game doesn't make sense on a Nintendo console, period. I don't know why that's
Yeah.
a thing they went
It's a
after. I don't
dog
know
and
its
pony show.
marquee. I would have, I mean,
It was,
I,
hey, we
well.
could play Skyrim now. Yeah, Skyrim's also a 7-year-old game.
Yeah.
That's
I
true.
would have I would have preferred that they got with Bethesda and made a new IP, made a made, make a game for the Switch, you know.
Bethesda wants they make such huge gigantic games, they don't want to take the time out to do fucking for something for Switch. They're like,
Yeah,
hey,
maybe.
listen, we could port you this. This works.
Yeah.
They're not getting
Yeah.
like what they're gonna
Maybe.
announce. Are they gonna announce Fallout New Vegas next year?
Nice.
No,
Nice.
because there's too much sex in that game.
It's true. Dragon Quest Heroes 1
Yeah, I
and
get your
2,
point.
never playing them. Big IPs though.
Yep.
They'll do fine.
Well, there's actually four Dragon Quests because there's Dragon Quest 10 and 11, and then there's Dragon Quest Heroes 1 and 2. So there's
10
actually
and
four
11,
Dragon.
I thought was like Japan exclusive though, sounded like.
Well, but the one another one of the few upsides of the system, it's not region locked.
That's right. That's
So all
correct.
those games are available.
Yeah, but
And
I don't want to read
that's
something
been a
new.
big complaint about Nintendo for a long time. I mean, there's just to find silver lining. I have a few items that are silver linings
There's a lot
on
of silver lining
this
sometimes.
line.
You know, I'm not here to
I don't
bash
know.
100%.
I'm pretty disappointed, but that's one of the silver linings. It's not region locked. One of the big complaints about Nintendo is that a lot of really good games never make it to the US because they decide that it doesn't fit you American sensibilities, and it's too, we had the Gamergate thing a few years ago about censoring games or changing content in games because, in Japan it's okay to fuck an animated 12-year-old, but it's not okay to do that in the US.
Probably shouldn't be
Just
okay to do in Japan.
because it's not a real 12-year-old, it's a cartoon, so it doesn't count. That's
Yeah,
their
still acting like a
their
fucking.
thinking.
I get it, but.
Yeah, I mean, I it's I can I understand both sides of that argument, so I don't really have a dog in that fight, but that's just the most, egregious example I could think of. So all of these Japan onlys will be available in the US.
I'll never play them
Obviously
because I
not
don't
going to be
want
in English. I'm
Yeah,
not
I
going to
don't
play them
want
either.
to. I couldn't. I couldn't.
But they could do a DLC, you know, translation. So they don't have to port the whole game. They can just DLC upgrade.
They won't. It would be like, hey, if you want to play it, you can play it, but we're not fucking helping you play it.
You're probably right, but
Octopussy Traveler. No idea what that is.
That's the Square Enix game, the Final Fantasy 3 looking game.
Octopath.
Yeah.
Okay. That'll do whatever. I have no idea. I had no interest.
I would buy that game, not for $60, but I would buy that game at some point. But it's an SNES game. That game should be on mobile, like literally on an iOS tablet.
Just Dance 2017. Why do they still make Just Dance? I have no idea. Who the fuck buys them?
Somebody, apparently. I've got that written down here somewhere too. Here it is, Just Dance. Checking these off as we go.
Yeah. We got EA FIFA. Typical EA, this would be their one and done. They're going to throw FIFA and you'll never see a EA sports game on the console again.
I did see NBA 2K18. Is that an EA game? Oh, no. 2K is 2K Sports.
Yeah, 2K. Yeah. Again, any sports game one like that, it's always one and done. They're there for the console launch and that's it.
Yeah.
Redout, I have no fucking idea what that is.
Redout, I didn't see that one, but if that's that was a game, there was a Redout game. It's a racing game, and it was on the GameCube, and it was kind of an underground sleeper hit. So that might be something. I didn't see that one.
Puyo Puyo Tetris. Great, we got Tetris, guys.
Yeah, that's a Japanese gimmick.
Yes,
$40 to play Tetris.
My Game Boy Tetris literally still works.
Sonic Mania Collector's Edition. That's gonna be multi-platform. You're gonna get that everywhere except the Collector's Edition. This could probably get, looks like it has an amiibo. It probably has some stuff that you won't get anywhere else. Sonic Mania is. That's what we do a whole show on Sonic if we wanted to.
Yeah. That goes back to my point. It's an SNES game. You know, they didn't even show it. That you could just see it because in between on the Treehouse event, in between moments, they had, you know, we'll be right back, and they would show video from the event where people were playing games, and you could see Sonic Mania. It looked really cool, it's still just not SNES, Genesis era. But it, I mean, it looks cool. But
me and Chris were actually talking about that while you were doing when you have some troubles, like the whole story behind that game and stuff. That's not Sega. Sega didn't make that game.
Really?
So everyone thinks Sega's rescuing Return because they were like, "Oh, 2D. Sega's gonna bring back." No, it was a fan made project by a group. They were making new levels and everything. Sega saw it. Instead of shutting it down, they didn't buy their company, but they're like sponsoring them. They were making the game. So
that actually makes me more interested in it in a way.
So still shows you that Sega has no idea how to rescue Sonic, but at least they know that other people might know how to.
Yeah.
That's spring 2017. That's multi-platform though. If you have a Switch and you like the Switch, you'll buy it on Switch. If you don't have one, you'll buy it somewhere else. It's not going to sell.
Well, good. System. Good. So I could buy it on another system.
Lego City Undercover. I feel like that was a game that came out fucking like years ago.
It did. It's on the Wii U.
And they're going to charge $60 for that.
What is it like?
What does it do? It's like GTA, from what I understand.
It's Lego GTA, but you know, happy.
I've heard it's actually, it's like $20 on the Wii U right now. I've almost bought it about 1,000 times. I've heard it's super fun.
Oh, yeah, but it's a Lego game.
I play a lot of Lego games, and I'm kind of like, eh. Plus, Lego Dimensions keeps coming out.
I never played Star Wars Episode 4. Seven yet.
Seven? Yeah, I haven't played it either.
GameStop has it for $60. There's no way it launches for $60.
You would hope.
That's basically a Skylanders is coming. You'd expect that.
Yeah.
Binding of Isaac.
I didn't see that one.
I didn't expect that, but again, it's a nice game to have. It's a, you know, it's an older game. It's a nice game to have. I guess it fills up the library. It's not a system seller. You can play that fucking anywhere you want. And the complete collection of the Minecraft story mode.
Yeah.
That's basically.
I have some more.
Be a Bomberman.
Yeah, the Bomberman was one.
It's gonna be a launch title, so watch out for that.
I did see them play that
Super
briefly.
NES.
Yeah, I had no interest. I had no interest in it.
Yeah, I'll be. Well, I love Bomberman, and I'll be generous and say it's a Nintendo 64 style game or era game. There's a Dragon Ball game coming. There's something called Fast RMX that I saw in the background. Some sort of racing game. They didn't show anything about it. They spent a fucking hour on this game called Snipper Clips, which is another game that could very easily be bundled.
That's a launch title. $20.
Is that a launch title? It's a part, Chris is giving me a look. It's a two player, well, theory. It's one it's to four players. Game. It's a puzzle game. It's one to four players puzzle game. They've got Has Been Heroes, which is another roguelike, I believe. And then, as I wrote down from watching the stream last night, hypothetical Sega games. Sega is committed to making some games at some point in the future. And then there's something called from Atlas, the developer. They said the name of the game, but it was some gibberish, Japanese gibberish. I didn't know what it was.
It was a CGI.
So I think that covers it. No Smash announced. No Super Mario Maker announced.
No Metroid. Is Metroid even a thing anymore? Like, isn't the last Metroid game like the Other M? That's like a
Had that. They did one on the DS, but it was like an arena, like a MOBA. It was like an arena battle game. People shit on it before it ever hit the shelves because it wasn't traditional Metroid. So there's, if you look online, there's like a zillion people shitting on it. But then there's also this group of people who actually bought it and played it. Like, you know, I get it. It's not really Metroid, but it's actually super fun and you should check it out. So I don't know. Clearly they're just rehashing their fucking glory years here. Yeah. So I imagine they're going to make, you know, Super Metroid 2 here in the near future.
Nintendo hardcore fanboys that are just blinded by the fucking Mario. See, what I like about people, if they're listening to this, they think, oh, we're just fucking shitting all over Nintendo and stuff. If you're a Super Nintendo fan, it's not. We're not. We're just looking at it for what it is. We're seeing what it is.
I am a super fanboy, and I'm not. I'm nonplussed by this.
And that is why. That is why Nintendo just gets away with the shit over and over again, because. And then they like to make the same excuse. Oh, it's just Microsoft fanboys, Sony fanboys, or Nintendo doesn't want to be like everyone else. Yeah, they're haters. No. Everyone hates Nintendo. No, we're just seeing what is happening here. You're charging me $2.99 for my biggest problem, not to go backwards, is the system fine. The games eventually, we're assuming eventually is going to come out.
Right.
What am I getting for that system with the prices that you were charging me for this system?
Nothing. Not enough.
From what I can go, if I'm a gamer, right, and I haven't had a new system in a while, I just got my tax return, I don't have any new system.
Mm-hmm.
Why am I buying a Nintendo Switch with, okay, Zelda, but nothing really else when I can get the Xbox, PlayStation, all that game library with a game already?
Without, I mean, it sounds stupid, but A, it's a standard, and B, it can motivate somebody to buy it without Netflix streaming and Hulu streaming and all this other shit. Did they announce that though? No, they didn't. They didn't even mention it, and I imagine it's not going to be there. I don't know. I guess it might be on the Wii U. It might be there. But personal experience, when I bought my PS4, my computer died for like the 1,000th time. I know viewers of my stream will be shocked to hear my computer died. And I had an option. I said, well, I can build a new computer, or hey, I can go buy this PS4 for a fraction of the cost. And 90% of what we do on the computer is watch Netflix and Hulu and, you know, these other streaming services. It's all built into the system and I get to play games on it. And at that time I paid $400 for my PlayStation. So, you know, those things do come into play when you're thinking about buying.
I heard this excuse today. It's like, oh yeah, you know, the other games, they don't have any exclusives. It's all third party, so they try to sell you on that streaming stuff. And this is a real excuse I heard today. Nintendo has all like the first, but those third party games, apparently. Yeah, and those third party games, because these people are living in the past with nostalgia.
Yeah.
And I have a PlayStation, right? And I'm not a fanboy of any. I love my PlayStation, but I'm a PlayStation guy. I'm a video game guy. I had all the systems last gen. I just happened to get the PlayStation 4 instead of the Xbox One. I don't know what I'd do if I had my PS4. I love it. I watch Twitch through it. I watch Netflix through it. Hulu through it. I can stream from it. I can just do so much shit with it. And what's great is the Switch is going to have Netflix and stuff. Well, we're assuming. It's probably going to have it. But the PlayStation version is higher definition when I want to stream through it. They support 4K. The new ones.
Yeah, they're going to support
4K streaming. all this stuff is new, and then here comes the console launching, Nintendo launching their console that is already 5 years behind. Other than the Joy-Cons, that's new technology, but.
Well, and you make an interesting point about the PlayStation Pro. I fully expect a mid-generation refresh. Right now, I'm already expecting a refresh on the Switch because that battery life is garbage.
Does Nintendo ever do refreshes though? When were they ever come out with? When did they ever come out with a Slim? Yes.
Well, quote unquote. Not necessarily the Slim, not necessarily the Slim, but they have done refreshes. The Wii U that you and I have any is a refresh. The 32 gigabyte Wii U is a refresh. The original had 16.
Okay.
The Wii had a refresh. I don't remember the difference between that one and the predecessor. GameCube did not have a refresh. The 64 had the new colors, but it's a console, or sorry, a cartridge-based system, so not so much. But the Nintendo and the Super Nintendo both had refreshes because they came out with, at the end of their life cycles, they came out with the Famicom-style look to them on both systems. Really? The Game Boy had a dozen refreshes
before
we got to Game Boy Advance.
Game Boy Color, all that kind of stuff.
Yeah, Game Boy Pocket, Game Boy, they had they even had the Game Boys that had, they were literally different colors as opposed to the gray. They were still the pea green, but they were different gray. And the same, it's always the same thing. Better battery life, better battery life. And they're saying either 2.5 or 3.5, depending on who you ask, to 6.5 hours. Generally, any tech company, when they quote a battery life, it's usually a third less than what they say. I think on a good day, you're going to get 3 hours battery life on the Switch Mobile. I think that's exactly why so many of these games look like SNES, because they're less resource intensive and they're going to make that battery last longer.
It's common sense. Zelda's going to run at 1.5 to 2 hours dumbed down. They could say six hours because a game like fucking that Snip game could run probably fucking 5-6 hours. Like that's it's dog and pony shows.
Yeah, but you're going to have a refresh on this system probably within 2 to 3 years.
Not to get off Nintendo, but like, isn't that the thing with the world today? Battery life.
Yeah. Oh, 100%.
Phones and everything. They always want to come out with new tech, new software, new everything.
Better, more, cool, powerful, more powerful, more powerful,
more powerful. More powerful. When are they going to start researching these batteries?
Well, they are researching the. Sorry, go ahead, Chris. Go ahead.
I was going to say the reason that the batteries are getting better along with the technology, but the technology is so power intensive. I believe it's outpacing the achievements in batteries.
The battery technology is not shrinking fast enough. That's the problem.
No.
So the battery technology, they really, and this is the history of battery technology. They have to start big and then they work it down to small. And so, yeah, like Vinny said, every time they come out with a new, you know, piece of hardware, a new processing chip, oh, it's more powerful. It's just like Nintendo. Every time Apple comes out with a new thing, oh, look, he's playing all these games on his phone, da, 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 da. But it destroys the battery. And so the question always becomes, what about battery life? The batteries aren't shrinking fast enough to keep up with the speed with which we increase the processing power and where you make shit smaller. They're not keeping up with how quickly processors are getting smaller and faster, mm-hmm. smaller and faster.
You know, because like, what was I going to say? No, it's if because of this problem with the batteries. Why are they selling us a system that you cannot replace the battery? This thing isn't going to work in 10 years.
Yeah.
Like the battery's going to be all messed up and you'll be able to take it anywhere. Cause unless you take it to the freaking guy to fix it.
You know, I'm going to say you're probably wrong. And I'll tell you why, because go back and look at NES cartridges. The ones that you could save on, they had a battery and everybody said, well, what are you going to do in 5 years? You can't replace the battery. Well, you sure as shit can by then. So, I mean, it's the same thing with the iPhone, you know, if they quit making iPhones, obviously nobody replaces their iPhone battery because they just go get a new iPhone.
Right.
But you could in 2017 change your iPhone battery if you wanted to. So while I agree with
not
what you're
yourself.
Saying, yeah, you can. Yeah, you can.
Really?
It's not hard. You gotta get the tool. You get a toolkit. I got a toolkit off Amazon that will, and I bought it because of Nintendo, because I was buying all these old games, and a lot of them you need to take them apart and clean them and you know, refurbish them, because they're just so distressed and disregarded for so many years, and you know, they just get shit built up on them. You got to refresh them or refurbish them. So you get a $12 toolkit. I can open any phone for $12 toolkit. Wow. Yeah, that stuff is ubiquitous at this point. I can change the glass, the screen on my phone. I can do all that stuff now. I don't think that's going to be the problem. It's nice. One nice thing is that you don't have to dock it to charge it. They do have the portable USB. It's nice that it's USB-C, so it is a universal standard. If you know, it's a new standard. It's not widely used yet, but it is a universal standard. You can charge with USB-C, so it does have that going for it. But if I'm looking at portable, I'm getting a 3DS. I'm not getting the Switch.
Yeah, I like, not to see use the expression for the third time, but again, I think the whole Switch gimmick, as cool as it sounds, dog and pony show. How many people actually taken the thing with them? Now it's nice that you can take it out and play it. At home, that was what we wanted, Bangs. I think we talked about that.
Right, yeah.
We're not taking it out. The football games on the television, we're watching that. We're pulling it out. We get to play it. Why it stays plugged in. We're not playing it running it off battery.
Yeah. The example I used today was sometimes some of my friends that stream later in the day and they're playing Mario Kart and they want me to jump in. For me to play Mario Kart, I have to come into my office. I have to fire. I mean, everything's plugged into one power strip, like all my lighting, my Wii U, it's all plugged into the same power strip. So I have to turn on everything in order to play Mario Kart, you know, because the Wii U tablet doesn't reach the 20 feet to my bedroom from my office room. So that's like the one nice thing about the Switch, is that I can take it to, you know, my bedroom, obviously, because it has no signal loss. And then with the USB-C, I can plug it into an outlet there. I don't have to bring the whole fucking dock with me.
Speaking to play and charge the docks, you can buy another dock.
I saw that.
Buy more docks. Oh, but God. Here's the thing too. Again, with pricing. So well, first the AC adapter.
$90.
Yeah, the AC adapter is $30. Is that right for that? That seems a little okay.
For a USB-C,
it's the Nintendo Switch AC adapter with the the C.
For an official quote unquote, that's on par.
Okay.
But you can absolutely get them cheaper.
So if you're willing to. Essentially, if you want to set up a new docking station in another room, it's gonna run you about $120 for the before tax with the AC adapter and the dock. The dock should 90. Come with a
Nintendo's website, they're showing Switch dock set $90. It's got the dock, it's got the USB-C cable, and it's got an HDMI cable.
That's okay. Well,
yeah, that's actually not bad. I mean, that's when you figure that that's theoretically a third of the system.
The dock's not just a holder. It upscales. So you're not just paying for a holder for fucking $90. You're paying, it's going to upscale.
Well, since we're talking about mobile, do you think the Switch means the end for like a DS or that sort of console thing?
Yes, if it sells.
You think so? The DS?
When they launched the DS, Nintendo came out and said, we're not getting rid of Game Boy Advance. This is a separate thing. It's not going the way. The DS sold like fucking gangbusters, and GBA got dropped like a hot potato. Nintendo does this. This is what they do. So they're going to float the Switch as a console / portable. If it blows up and 3DS sales slow down, look at what they did this year at Black Friday. They had like three special edition 3DSs this year. Yeah. They had the one with Amazon that came with Mario World, which fuck, I almost bought it. How many times am I going to buy Super Mario World? The answer apparently is a lot.
Yeah,
I almost bought the Amazon only 3DS came with Mario World. They had the two Black Friday ones. There was like a spaceship or not spaceship, Milky Way design on it. They had four, because they had the Milky Way design. Then they had like a black and a white one that had like a silhouette of, you know, Mario characters, basically. So they had four new 3DSs come out at Black Friday. That's something Nintendo usually does when they think they might be retiring, or as they start pushing it.
But
so if the
Is a battery life going to come into play?
Yeah, probably. If the Switch sells the, but that won't matter. If they sell a fuck ton of Switches and they stop selling 3DSs, they will retire the 3DS. It'll be 100% Switch. Now, I did hear that part of the reason the Switch is the way it is has to do with system architecture, is that it does make it easier to develop games in parallel for both systems. So some of the architecture of the Switch is built off the 3DS architecture, so it's easier to make games for both systems or to port games back and forth.
Makes sense. So
That'd be cool to download a lot of those games, because can you download 3DS games or DS games on the Wii U?
Oh, the Wii U.
I don't know. I'd have to check the Virtual Console.
I don't know. Yeah, you have to check.
I don't think so. Don't think so, because they have the Virtual Console for the DS, and it's completely different stuff.
Well, we're moving in a nice direction here. Oh, with virtual. This is some of the stuff that they haven't really. The system comes out in less than 2 months. Mm-hmm. This was my biggest thing. Again, what my friend doesn't give a fuck about it, you know, because he's a Nintendo fanboy. They didn't show me enough of that shit. They didn't show me like UI, Virtual Console. They didn't show you starting up the game. I want to see how it looks when it opens up. What's the home screen look like? How do I start my games? They didn't show you like putting a game into the thing, they wasn't like, oh hey, this is where you're gonna put your game into. Like,
it's not exciting.
It was weird. Like, it was. They didn't show that stuff.
Yeah, but I saw something online where it's just SD cards.
No, I saw the thing, but I didn't physically get to see them actually like put it in.
You want to see the home screen?
Yeah, I want to see the home screen. I want to see them turn it on. Yeah, yeah. I want to see what the UI is going to look like.
Yeah,
and all that stuff. And
yeah, and they like briefly mentioned that there's going to be some sort of online system that's going to be available at launch, but none of the good stuff's going to be available until October when they start charging for it. How much that's going to be, nobody knows.
That, wow. Yeah, I knew this was going to be a long fucking part. That online, it pretty much Nintendo just said, fuck it, we don't know how to do online, we'll outsource it, and it's going to be an app. That's our online.
Well,
partially, anyway, yeah.
So with Super Mario Maker, there was concerns that they weren't going to necessarily keep the servers up forever, because they don't really have a reason to.
Correct.
Like, if they're charging for servers,
then the charging is not going to be Wii U, though. Like, we're not going to, it's not, it's going to be Switch. You're not going to have to buy.
I'm not saying paying for, you know, your internet connectivity or the store or whatever, you know, whatever is going to be backwards compatible. You know, it's not going to pay for Wii U titles like Super Mario Maker, but it may pay for, you know, the newer titles to continue to be supported longer.
Basically, it's another money grab by Nintendo. They see Xbox and PlayStation charging for online, so we're going to start doing it too. My thing is, what are you getting for it? Like, you're charging online. You get to play multiplayer together, but how many Nintendo games are we really going to be playing multiplayer? There's no fucking launch titles to come out.
Well, don't
talk Mario Maker, because that's not going to be on Switch.
There's a couple things to that real quick. I think charging, not having charged for it is part of the reason why it sucked. When PlayStation and Xbox started charging for it is when it started to develop. So I think charging for it at least gives the indication that you're going to, the theory you would think is that that money is going into developing that platform.
In theory. And I agree. I don't have a problem with them charging for it. I want to know what am I getting?
Well, you're getting a game a month, at least. However,
not really.
From what
That's
I
pretty cool.
But from what I hear,
not really.
You only get to play the game for that month. It's not like PlayStation and Xbox where you can. So with PlayStation and Xbox, Chris, because you don't have either one, do you?
No. Okay. I have one console. It's the Wii U.
Okay, so I have PS4. I have PS Plus, which is their online system. Every month they give me at least two free games.
You get two free games a month.
But at least I get two free games. As long as I'm a subscriber to PS Plus, I own those games. I can play them as long as I want. There's now been no official announcement, but when you read their Nintendo's press release regarding their online platform, you get the game for the calendar month. And next month it's a new game. and it goes away.
Oh,
it
goes, they take it away from you?
It goes, no, it goes a deep, this legit burns my ass, this thing. Yeah, I did too. I think they're just spitting in the face of their fans. So, like Banks just said, Xbox and PlayStation, they give you 2 free games a month for their system. You keep it regardless. And here's the thing. The games, it's a lot of indie games, but sometimes you get a real gem. The one thing I'll say, you say, the games are from the current system, PS4 or Xbox One.
Yeah.
And you get to keep them.
Nintendo flat out said these are NES, SNES.
You're getting games that are
through their library.
20 fucking years old, they're going to give you. And hey, guess what? You get to play for the month that we're allowing you to, and then it goes away. So, 20.
Wait. For free, though, but
you get to play for free
because you're subscribing. Not free, you're subscribing.
You're subscribing.
Yeah, you're getting it. You get it free with your subscription. But can you buy the game and not have it go away?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know. They haven't really announced anything.
You're assuming if you want the game, you can buy a virtual console and keep it. That's not the point. The point is, these other systems are giving us free games for current gen systems, yet Nintendo's going to try to do the same thing. Except, hey, we're going to let you play games that are 20 years old, but only for the month. Right. And you get like one or two of them. Do you see what I'm getting? What I'm saying there?
It goes back to what we were talking about earlier. It's just the, you know, nostalgia is Nintendo, you know, and Nintendo's nostalgia. I mean, we're playing Zelda, we're playing Mario. It's the same stuff that's been.
It just feels
forever.
Like a fuck you to the fans, really. Like okay, you don't have to give us anything, but if the other systems are doing it and you get to keep them, and why aren't you being on par with them? It's not like they're giving us Wii U games or Wii games or GameCube games, any N64 games, SNES, NES, and you get to play them for whatever.
And this is my criticism of Nintendo, and it always has been. I made the joke a moment ago, how many times am I going to buy Super Mario World? The reason you don't get to keep those games is because they're going to keep selling them to you. For all of Vinny's talk about money grabs, this one is a money grab. But there is one nice thing to it. Chris, I think you were going to say it about online multiplayer, maybe?
Yeah, so what the rumor I heard was, I don't even know if it's a rumor. I think it's true.
I think it's confirmed, yeah.
Confirmed that one of the really old Mario Kart games is going to be multiplayer online.
They've said that all of the old games they put out are going to have online multiplayer.
Wow, man. Yeah. I don't know why that blows my mind, but it's like...
Because I you're living in really nostalgia. Cool. That doesn't really do much.
Well, it is nostalgia. It's going to be fun to fucking pull up Super Contra and play with somebody and, you know, just go through it. It's 100% nostalgia. Maybe. It's cool. Like, yeah, it's nostalgia, and I get that, and it's super cool. The problem is that it's on the backbone of all the other stuff we already brought up, which is that the whole system is nostalgia. If the system was, if the games didn't feel like SNES games, this particular idea would be super badass on its own in a bubble. But it's
sure
with everything else.
I don't want to.
They could have done that with the Wii U, right?
Yeah. Well, Nintendo's always 5-10 years behind.
They could have done it with the Wii.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The Wii had online capability. It just sucked.
I don't want to
sweep. I played Smash Brothers on the Wii online.
Mario Kart. Yeah.
I don't want to sweep this under the rug. Let's keep on with this multiplayer thing. So Nintendo still doesn't know how to do online. All right. Maybe what they're doing is going to be revolutionary, but it's going to be an app now. Voice chat is going to, like, so finally they're going to have voice chat for games.
Everything's going to run through your phone.
But everything's going to run through a phone. My Homer friends, it's the greatest fucking thing. It's 2017. You can't include voice chat in your goddamn console. So essentially, if I want to talk to you with my headset, I'm up there with my fucking gay ass joy motes. I got to be tethered instead of just plugging, say, my USB cable into my system or my wireless thing. I got to be tethered to my phone. So now my phone. Life. My phone's going to be dangling somewhere, or I got to lay it somewhere, but I'm going to be standing, or I'm going to have to make sure my cable's long enough to get it. I don't know.
It's about battery life. They're literally outsourcing the hardware to your phone or tablet. It's battery life.
I have a question. What do you guys think about the fact that maybe they have not been including voice chat because of how abusive
they've said that
online?
Yeah, that's not a question. They've said that's why they haven't.
Oh, they've said that.
Yeah, because Nintendo's a family console, and because even with parental controls and all that, it's still impossible to manage. They weren't going
to
do it.
So it's easy to manage. If you want voice chat, you have to be friends with the people. They have to be on your friends list.
Well, Yes.
Why can't you have voice chat through friends?
But as we saw with the Wii U, they can't. They haven't really figured out how to handle friends lists either.
Yeah,
it's only, you know, they've only been doing it for 10 years now.
I mean, you look at the Super Mario Maker bookmark site, and you could tell like they really don't know what they're doing online.
They have no
and the bookmark site was an app that they came back and did that because what they launched was so shitty. Because Super Mario Maker didn't have any system, and everyone was like, "What the fuck are you doing, Nintendo?" So then, about a month or two into the system, they said, "Oh, we launched the bookmark site," and you're like, "Oh, well, this sucks, but it solves all of our problems."
You can't search for shit like it's just. I don't know. And again, the nostalgia, big N, fucking blinded being like, oh, Nintendo doesn't want to have all that stuff. They're their own independent thing. And but with the online, yeah, sure.
Let me ask you a question real quick, Vinny, before we move on, because I want to talk about voice chat. Because you play a lot of games that are sort of predicated on voice chat, and I don't particularly. Do you use the built-in voice chat function? Because for me, my instinct would be to use Discord.
Yeah. If I'm streaming online, but over if I'm on PlayStation, I'm playing Call of Duty with my friends or we use the party mode. We don't hop online.
Oh, dude,
I'm not gonna go to my computer.
I'd grab my tablet. I would still use Discord. That would be my instinct. Would be to use Discord.
I tried to play Left 4 Dead 2, you know, like a week or two ago with my buddy who's you know across town, and we tried to do the in-game thing. It didn't work, so we just went over to Discord because Discord just works.
Yeah. And then is that the game I jumped into? Was that session
where I jumped in? I think so. Yeah.
So I was able to jump in to Discord first and talk to you guys and get going. So
PC with friends is one thing, but even still, if I'm playing, say, you know, something on PlayStation or Xbox, and all of a sudden it's against someone I don't know, and we're just talking, we're just bullshitting. I'm not going to be like, hey, why don't you come over to this Discord channel on your computer? But, you know, you just send them a quick... They make it so simple. That's the thing.
Yeah.
Like, you don't have to go through 10 steps. You just click their name, send chat invite. There you go.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
But I still want one more thing on this. With their online service, we don't know exactly the details. It could be revolutionary. Right. We don't know. We don't know how much they're charging. I will say this. If they're going to want to stay... If they're going to charge just as much as Xbox...
$5 a month, so
people again, I'm taking PC out of it. PC can do everything for fucking free. Xbox, for as far as console goes, people say Xbox gets the online right. They do everything. That's right. The way they do. I'm just saying what they say. You know,
which makes sense coming out of Microsoft. I mean, they should be.
Yeah, the way they do voice chat, everything. Best. They're the best. Sony came in, started charging because the PS3 was terrible compared to the Xbox 360.
Mm-hmm.
PS4 came on. And they started charging. It was a lot better. Still doesn't reach the Xbox levels, but it's a lot better. It's really good. You know, you don't really have a lot of problems. If Nintendo Switch decides, okay, listen, we're going to start charging you now, just like these other two consoles, if they're going to charge the same amount, I expect to meet certain standards as some of the other systems are doing.
I agree with you, but I don't expect that.
Expect it either.
Honestly,
it's kind of sad, Bangs. It's kind of sad.
Because knowing Nintendo the way I do, because you have to, we look at these things from American perspectives, and the Japanese perspective is so different. And so I understand Sony is a Japanese company, but Microsoft certainly is not. I suspect, based on what I know about Japanese culture and what I know about Nintendo as a company, they're looking at going, these companies have an online system service. Our complaints, the complaints we get on Twitter and Reddit or whatever other bullshit, are that we don't have an online service. They're charging for it. We can charge for it. But we're going to do it our way. We're going to do it the Nintendo way. And so I'm going to tell you right now, Vinny, do not go in expecting it to be anything compared to what you get from Xbox or PlayStation. It's not.
No.
I suspect it's going to be on par with the Wii U, except now it's going to cost money.
Yeah, it's gonna spit in the face of fans, because that's what Nintendo does, because when you're a super fan of Nintendo, you're blinded by the big N. They can do no wrong.
Nintendo is a, for better or worse, and we could talk about all kinds of examples, Nintendo is... the brand, that is the product. They do not make video games, they make Nintendo. You know, to take it to another example, WWE wrestling is the same way. They are WWE, they don't even call it wrestling anymore, it's sports entertainment. Chris, to put it in perspective, they created new words to describe their product because the brand is the brand, And there are no wrestlers, there are superstars. There are no fans, there is the universe. They have new words, like going to fucking Starbucks. There's new words for everything because it separates themselves from the competition. Nintendo doesn't have competition because they don't recognize their competitors.
Yeah, because you know when you watch wrestling, now that analogy works for that. You can't, it doesn't work because they're the number one dog like WWE is, and that, you know, they're just a thing. But it works in the sense. It works in the sense where Nintendo, like, they're so in their own world, same as WWE. Better wrestling you can find elsewhere. You can find a lot better wrestling elsewhere. Same like you can find a lot better games. But they have their fans, and the fans won't look anywhere else. And they're their own you thing. You know, it's Nintendo. That's what it drives. I think Nintendo doesn't even piss me off. It's the fucking people. I think. It's like, wake up, you know, open your eyes a little bit. I'm not trying to shit on Nintendo. And then, you know,
but you're right. No, but you're right, Vinny. It is the bubble because the Wii U sold really well in Japan.
Yeah. No. Yeah. And you said it before, too. It's the blind, you know, when you bat shit on Nintendo, oh, you're just an Xbox or Sony fanboy. Everyone hates Nintendo, blah, blah, blah. We're just seeing it like it is.
Yeah, 100%.
That's all we're trying to do here. This is how we saw it. We had no. You had a huge dog in the race, Banks. You're a super fan.
Well, we talked about it during the Switch event, knew that in January we were going to do another show about the Switch, and the expectation was Vinny was going to shit on everything, and I was going to defend everything, and Chris would be somewhere in the middle. Boy, did Nintendo fucking lay a log, or whatever the phrase is. Lay an egg.
I don't want to sit here and shit on Nintendo. I'm not a Nintendo hater. I'm a hater, but I don't want to be a hater. It's not like, oh, fuck Nintendo. Like, I want to love Nintendo. I want to love it. Nintendo was my first system, and I skipped a huge generation. I bought a Wii U. Like, I play Nintendo. I just expect, I want more. Now, if this was their system, their launch, and they said 250 or 200 to 250 comes with a game, and this is what we're doing, fine. I can get behind that. For me, the problem,
I could take 300 with the game.
If it came with that
1-2 Switch for 300, I probably still wouldn't be a first day buyer, but I would go. Yeah, okay. Sounds about right.
That's my problem with the system. It's not so much the system itself; it's how they're acting like it's this fucking thing, and the pricing is out of control. It is $70 for a pro controller. Yeah. $70.
It's completely well, and that pro controller is no. Oh, that's a.
Let's start talking about
that's
these controllers
PS4 controller. Now. Hold on. It's because literally no different than the Wii U Pro controller. Yeah. It's the exact same thing.
And, well, I think that thing's a Switch
because my earphones fell out.
I think the thumb drives are Switch. I think they copied the 360 again. Or maybe they're not. Basically, it's a copy of a 360.
Here for comparison, here's a PS4 controller I just happen to have sitting here. It's similar. It's like a cross between these two controllers. So yeah, it's probably like a 360 controller.
It's a 360 controller.
But a brand new PS4 controller is $40. How are you getting away with that price point? It has.
Yeah.
They're going to say that
come with it.
The PS4 controller. PS4 controller has rumble. It's got a touchpad. It has the accelerometers and the gyroscopes and all that shit in it. It's got all of those things built in. It's $40. You cannot get away with that price point, Nintendo.
Well, hold on a second. How much was it at release, though?
The brand new, the updated one that just came out is $40.
Wow. They just updated it.
They just released. This isn't it, but they just released an updated version to go with the new PS Pro, and it's $40.
Launch.
I think the MSRP on it is $60, but it's $40 everywhere.
Yeah, I think at launch, I think if you bought a second controller, I think it was $50 or $60, but that's still $10 less than what they're charging for, you know, what you buy now. So, and here's what's even crazier: if the Joy-Cons are $80, and hey, that's your Joy-Cons though. Say you want to put them into the grip. That grip is what, $30. So if you want to buy a whole new controller with them, it's $110.
Okay, those Joy-Cons
show up. I'm running out of scotch.
Those Joy-Cons are so small. How many people do you think are going to freaking lose them?
Not even the point. There's no reason for those things. And I have my office is nothing but video games. There's no reason for them to not be on par with a Wii U controller or a Wii controller.
Price-wise.
They're the same. As far as size or
same
as
price point. They're the same thing. Now, I thought it was bullshit when the Wii controller and the Nunchuck were sold separately. That made no sense to me then.
Right.
There's no reason. I think these are, you can get This is a first gen. This is a first gen Wii controller. The second gen has the PS Plus or PS Plus, the Wii U Plus, Wii Plus. What the fuck's the name of this thing? Built in, so they're a little bit longer. But one of those, brand new, branded. They come in Mario paint job, Luigi paint job, Yoshi, Bowser, all that stuff. They're $15. So say, and I think the nunchuck is still separately. So let's say $30 for the whole kit and caboodle.
They're gonna sell it on the Nintendo name, and they're gonna say it's new technology. You know what Nintendo has turned into? Nintendo is the Apple of video games right now.
Peripheral.
Apple,
you know, you were always right. Been that way.
Well, but Apple, right. Apple created the smartphone. They were the masters at it, but now they haven't come off anything revolutionary in how long? But it's been Google.
They changed the charging cable to Lightning.
And they show off their new product and they act like they invented it. They're the new ones. This is revolutionary.
Yeah. Well, and the new iPhone has no headphone jack. You got to buy an adapter. Yeah. Well, I think it comes with one.
Yeah, so they sell their own shit.
You have to buy a dongle. Again, but Nintendo's always been like that. Go back to the Game Boy Advance and the GameCube. You know, they had like all of these games that were used the Game Boy Advance, and you had to get the charging cable. The charging cable was like $25 in 2003. You know, so that's always been Nintendo. Look at the NES. You had the pad, the running pad. You had the Advantage, the giant joystick controller. You had the four player adapter. I don't remember what it was called.
They love their accessories.
Oh yeah,
they love accessories because the profit margin across all industries. And you name any product in the marketplace, accessories have the highest profit margins.
Yeah, I'm not saying they're wrong with it. That's business.
It's business. But it's business. But they build it into their business model. They make products. Apple does this too. Apple and Nintendo, and I love Nintendo. But I've always I like my Apple iPhone. I have a lot of Apple products. I love both products. But my criticism of both is always the same. They build their products with built-in accessory needs.
Well, you know, wouldn't you be more enthusiastic about buying these accessories if they had, you know, the games that you wanted, you know, at least the Mario at the launch? You know,
100%. I mean, I have the adapter for the Wii U that lets you use a GameCube controller for Smash 4. $20 for that adapter for a game I've played one time. I still goddamn own it, though.
It's what Bang said. They make these games, they make the accessories built for like one game and people buy them, like the fucking wheel. The new wheel. What the fuck are you guys spending with that?
That was kind of fun. It was kind of fun to play Mario Kart Wii with the wheel. It was fun. The motion controls were fun. But if you're a competitive player, you don't use the wheel.
No,
because when you're playing Mario Kart competitively, you tap. You tap the turn. Everybody I know who plays seriously on Mario Kart doesn't hold a direction. You know, it's about micro movements, not wide movements.
I was so blown away.
$15 for two wheels. I cannot believe they're bringing back fucking Wii accessories. That was such a racket during the Wii. They were ubiquitous. They were a dime a dozen. Every 2-bit bullshit company released, you could get like for $30, you'd get that pack, and it had like a tennis racket and a baseball bat, and it had a bowling ball, you know, and you'd snap. They did zero. They were just hunks of plastic that served no purpose whatsoever.
You know, it's kind of funny.
Nintendo, really?
It almost seems like...
At least with the Wii, the wheel came bundled with Mario Kart. At least it came bundled with Mario Kart. It was a single box. Okay, fine. It's a gimmick. It's stupid, but you're basically giving it to me for free. Now you're charging me $15 for two of them.
Banks is raging.
I'm so disappointed with this launch. I'm heartbroken by this launch.
It seems like the Switch is Nintendo Wii 2. Basically,
100%. The Wii U failed. What worked for us? The Wii worked for us. Let's do that again.
Yeah,
100%. They took the one cool thing about the Wii U, the gamepad. Yep. They took all the shit that was in the Wii, which is motion controls, and they slapped them together. And they added a tablet.
That's the first thing that popped in my mind. Like, it's the first thought that popped in my mind when that presentation started. I'm like, they want to redo the Wii.
Mm-hmm. 100% they're redoing the Wii.
Yeah.
I will say this, so, it looks nice. I think it looks
yeah,
nice.
It's cool.
Oh,
yeah,
I think it looks real beautiful.
Yeah. Nintendo always has, you know, pretty consoles. Even when they're outside the realm, like the GameCube is like, it's weird, right? It's a giant box. Yeah. But it's weird in a cool way. You're like, I kind of like it. It's got the handle on it, yeah. You know.
I saw the comparison picture of the Switch and the gamepad. the Wii U gamepad. I'm like, the Wii U gamepad is so fucking ugly. The Switch is like so sleek and nice. It's
Well, and like those control, I mean, the Joy-Cons are like, they're unbelievably small, but like they look cute.
I was kind of into the Joy-Cons for two-player retro gaming. I'm like, I dig that. I like that I can, you know, hand, it basically comes with one controller or it comes with two if you're playing the right games. I was kind of, you know what? The teaser trailer that we did our first show on, which was what, September or October, that teaser trailer did more for me in the Switch than any of the shit we saw in the last 2 days did. They undid all of my excitement.
I'm with you. This was like a presentation, like I said earlier. It's a presentation we should have got at E3, not a month and a half out.
I do want to pat myself on the back.
Fan reaction and just see how you don't have any last seconds to tweak.
Right. I do want to pat myself on the back because we had a spirited debate in September, and I had a spirited debate on Reddit and on my channel and other people's streams in the chat. Basically, everybody and their mother said that the Switch was not going to have a touchpad. And I said, in 2017, you don't even make non-touch capacitive pads. And I was right.
They played that down so much. Like they said two sentences about it, and then that's it. They didn't say about any games taking advantage of it.
They probably won't, really. I mean, I actually don't disagree with that part, because to me, the touchpad is ubiquitous. That's how they come in 2017. You don't make a non-touch. If you're not making a TV, and realistically, they're probably, the only reason TVs don't have touchscreens is because they are coming in 70 inches at a minimum, more or less, you know.
They're coming in 70 inches. Yeah.
That's what she said.
Well, they can't over rely on the touchpad, because the game's gonna be docked. If you're playing at home, it's docked the entire time.
True.
So you can't over rely on
it. You could have like a lap dock, you know what I mean? You could have something. They're gonna make something where you could.
No, know what it is? Like Bang said, you just make a touchscreen these days, so it's always touchscreen. It's gonna be used when they port Wii U games over. It's maybe a couple games will have a feature here and there.
Yeah, and you won't be able to. You'll only be able to play them off the dock.
Yeah, and it'll be if it's a feature. Yeah. If it's on a current game when it comes out, it's a feature that you're gonna be able to do. It's just like clicking a button or something like that. It's not gonna change anything.
With the touchscreen, it gives me hope that there's going to be Super Mario Maker 2.
I'm surprised they announced that would have been the perfect game to announce for like a spring summer release, since Odyssey's not coming out till winter.
They could have even said that's a game that could come out at any time. I mean, they could have said 2018. I agree. They should not have disregarded Super Mario, because Super Mario Maker is what they call a killer app. That is the halo of Nintendo. Super Mario Maker moves systems. We know from all of us from personal experience.
Yeah, I bought it because
Super Mario Maker moves systems. All three of us bought a Wii U because of Super Mario Maker. I agree. They should have, and maybe not so much at the Japan conference, because we saw what that was about and it was weird. But at the Treehouse event this morning, which was much more game heavy and much more hardware heavy and much less into bullshit cow milking and jerking off, they absolutely should have said something about Super Mario Maker 2. Just hypothetically speaking, we're going to support Super Mario Maker for the foreseeable ongoing future. We're going to come out with a sequel in summer of 2018. We're going to continue to support the game on the Wii U.
Well, why not just call it? Yeah.
Yeah.
It should have been Super Mario Maker Deluxe, Super Mario Maker Switch or something.
Or whatever. I don't want a deluxe. I want a 2, because
I think 2, I think they need to, I think they will need to make, because I think Super Mario Maker, I think, well, maybe not Chris, because he's still streaming it, so I don't want to put him on the spot. But I think Vinny and I will agree that from our perspectives, Super Mario Maker is getting very long in the tooth. And so I think they do need a clear break. They can still support the servers. It can still be based on the same architecture, but they need a 2 with a whole new toy box of items.
Five months ago you're seeing the same levels over and over again. You're playing
somebody comes up with something new, it gets ripped off 1,000 times and usually in worse ways immediately.
So I think if you double the amount of tools you're gonna get
I think
stages.
I think if it's a port, if it's a port, you'll get more tools. If it's a 2, I think you're gonna see a little bit of an overhaul, more customization, more area to build, maybe top down. I don't think you're going to get that with a port. You'll get more items with a port. So I'm with you with the two. I'd like to see
more item control, you know, little things. I just think back to some when I was making courses, like I tried to make a ghost house level for Super Mario World. And there was these little, I don't know, like goblin looking guys that would just sort of do this wavy motion off screen. And you can't do that in Mario Maker. You can't make somebody come in from off screen and go off screen. You know what I mean? You have to put them on a track and kind of fake it. So I think, you know, it's completely off topic, but I'd like to see more item control, if you will.
No, yeah, I'm with you. Yeah, I think they can.
That might make it too complicated for the average user. We're sophisticated users in the world of Nintendo.
Okay, but so what? Okay, so that person doesn't use that capability. That doesn't mean I can't use that capability. And thinking about the Wii U, with a stylus, I should be able to point an object and draw the path it's supposed to take with the stylus.
Sure.
And choose an endpoint. You know what I mean? It's not complicated. I get why it's not in Mario Maker. Don't get me wrong. I understand why the pieces that are there and why certain pieces aren't there, because A, you have to draw a line in the sand somewhere, and B, they wanted, you know, to, they didn't know what it was going to be.
That's my point.
And you want to put restrictions initially, because you know you want people to sort of work with in a certain confines, but
restrictions breed creativity,
right?
Like you're gonna be more creative if you could only have three different colors of paint,
right?
Yeah, but
it requires you to think more. But unfortunately, that's not what happens. They just throw up on their Wii U pad, and whatever shows up is what we get submitted.
The Mario, I don't want this to turn to a Mario Maker thing, but the Mario world is so huge, though, that if you look at it, Mario Maker is super confined, so you could still have restriction, but you could just blow it up a little bit more. And it would be nice to see a server reset, you know, all new levels, you know, just wipe out everything with a Mario Maker 2 or Switch servers.
Sure. I agree with Chris, because I want those things to survive.
I'm saying.
But I also agree with Vinny that it would probably be better in the long run if that happened.
No, I'm saying you'll still have the Wii U servers up. You still have those levels there.
Oh,
I'm saying,
just have a clean
but with
Switch
the
server.
New game, it's a new server and a whole new Switch. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. But we don't expect. I don't expect any of that. We already see what Nintendo thinks when they do a DS Switch. It's like Nintendo doesn't know how to do. Like they have a success and they don't know like what to do, and they fuck up.
Well, because they it's like I said, they never want to. They never want to risk it in that respect. So, if they put something out and it ends up being killer, then they go back and they go, oh, never mind, this thing's going away.
Yeah, maybe
they never
Nintendo
want to commit.
Maybe they turn.
They really commit to going forward on their own.
Maybe they turn into hipsters. Like once it gets cool and stuff, it's not cool anymore. So they need to.
I think that's an Americanization of it. I think it's Japanese culture. I think that there even now there's such. I mean, Japanese CEOs resign over what today, what in America is a golden parachute in a lifetime of Mai Tais on the beach.
Yeah,
you know. They've only recently stepped away from suicide at the executive level, and they're still at suicide at the employee level. So their culture is just so different.
No, you heard that during the press conference of just
they don't
no clapping.
Yeah, they don't want to be they don't want to take that personal risk as an individual. They don't.
I'm sorry, I don't mean to keep going.
No, you're fine. I was done.
That was fucking weird. That guy that came out for Splatoon, fucking, I want to get that GIF. If Schmarcus is still here, can you work on that for me? I want that.
Where's Schmarcus here?
I want the GIF of that guy doing some weird shit. And it's like no one got applauses. It made it more awkward because the Japanese people probably loved it, but they're so respectful. They don't applaud, so it looked like it just died.
Oh, again, going back to wrestling, that's a big traditionally that's a big deal. When Americans talk about when they go to Japan to wrestle, it's weird because in America it's all about getting what they call, Mr. Christopher, a pop, which is getting that cheer, the scream, the loud applause. That's called a pop. And you don't get that in Japan because the better you are, the quieter they get. It's just now starting to bleed in wrestling anyway. They're starting to cheer because now there's so much crossover with streaming content, but that's Japanese culture. Applause is very polite. It's golf clapping, and it's at the end, and that's it, and it's a matter of respect.
How dare they?
I know, right? Fuck them.
Yeah, not to go back, but I just see Zelda Breath of the Wild is a 13.4 gigabyte download.
Okay.
So that's
well, that's contrary to what they said this morning, but yeah, which not surprising. Not surprising that what they and I were talking. It's not surprising what the cute girl with the silver hair said was wrong. So
she was cute from a distance, though. When they zoomed up on her, I was like, eh. Like don't get me wrong, I'd fuck her. I'd do dirty.
I was
things,
having a hell of a time streaming that thing. I had to put it on my tablet.
I watched it right through Twitch. No problem.
Well, yeah, it was on Twitch, but I was trying to Chromecast it, and the lag on it was so bad that I just had to, I couldn't do it. I had to put it on my tablet, and then so I've got, you know, a 10-inch screen, okay, but then I'm sitting here and I'm making notes, so I barely even.
I didn't watch, I popped in, I know Chris last night was doing I didn't want to be in there, yeah. I didn't want to be in there with you guys, because I don't want any, I didn't, you know, I wanted this to be the first time we heard each other's opinions.
Sure.
I popped in split second, and you were like even farther behind because you were capturing a delay, and we were seeing
and then
a delay.
Resending it.
Yeah, you're resending a delay.
Yeah, there was like a 3-minute delay by the time it got to us. Chris is I was in his stream. It was fun. Chris and I didn't really say much, but it was really interesting to watch other people's reactions.
Yeah,
his stream, his chat last night was very excited with what they saw on the Japan conference, which surprised me.
Well, you know, we're not. It's an emotional reaction. You're getting to see something for the first time, and it's like, oh, this is great. And you know, it's getting hyped up by the Nintendo people and whatever. And now that you know, the three of us are talking about this, it's like, oh, well, now I'm getting a little bit more perspective now that it's set in for a little while.
Do you think it was a misstep to not have Miyamoto at the Japan event?
Dude, I think he's always at American shit now. I think he like just wants to be an American. Like, I think does he live here now? Because he is
I have no idea.
He was on Jimmy Fallon. Like, he's on every American thing now, and you've never seen him in Japan anymore. So I don't know what the fuck he's doing.
I don't know. I mean, I guess I get why they did that thing in New York as well, because they apparently have a Nintendo store there. I'm a little pissed that there's a Nintendo New York and there's no Nintendo anywhere near me when their fucking headquarters is right here. But I was surprised that they did it there and not here.
What I was saying to Bangs earlier today, which I'm a fucking idiot. I literally bitch all the time. Hey, why is it TwitchCon ever do anything in New York? Why is any of these things in New York? The fucking Nintendo event is right there in New York. I live an hour and a half. I could have just fucking got out this morning and went.
Why? I mean.
Well, that's what I told him. Well, he would have had to pull an all-nighter, stand in line in the cold.
It would have been good for the show. I might have been able to try it. Maybe. I don't know. I don't know how long his lines were, but at least I could get a feel. I can say a little.
You could
bit
at least got a feel for the energy in the room, I guess.
Yeah. Sure. Yeah, but it doesn't seem like, you know, especially with the conversation we're having, it doesn't seem like.
Yeah, I don't think I wouldn't have done it.
Yeah,
I wouldn't have gone. I mean, we had, you know, VR events here. I couldn't be bothered to go three blocks to try out VR, you know.
So they announced Nintendo Switch Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2. I'm a huge Dragon Ball fan, Dragon Ball Z fan. I didn't play Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2 because the one thing about Dragon Ball, I love fucking Dragon Ball Z. Every game's fucking the same. Xenoverse was fun, but again, this is one of those. It falls in the category of it's multi-platform. I'm not playing it on Switch if I have my choice.
Oh, is it multi-platform? I'm not familiar. So.
Oh yeah, Xenoverse. It just came out, so it's on. Okay. It's on everything. And
I watched
a lot of online. So,
I watched some one of the YouTubers I watch played, I guess, the first one. I think he was playing Dragon Ball Xenoverse. It's like a sort of a adventure / fighting game, right?
You go
through a story, but then when you're engaged, when you fight an enemy, it goes into almost like a traditional PvP fighter.
In a way, yeah. The main story is Dragon Ball Z is old as fuck. It's younger here in America because it came here later.
It is. It's super old.
Every game is just a rehash of the same fucking story. What they did was you go back in time and the story is a little bit different and you correct it. It's fun. It's gimmicky. It's what is what it is. You create your own guy. But yeah, where are we? What didn't we cover?
I got a couple things still on my list, and I'll just hit these as bullet points. We kind of touched on it. I felt like and continue to feel like this console is for Japanese and niche audiences only, that it's not going to be for the general market. I don't think the general marketplace is going to respond to this system.
Hold on a second, because who do you think the general marketplace is? Is it gamers? Or is it like
because the general marketplace? I don't care. You can call it what you want.
Well, because the Wii, I mean, we're calling this the Wii number two.
Sure.
And the Wii was a big hit with, you know, basically families.
I don't think Switch gets anywhere near those numbers.
Price point.
Not think at that price point, not with this library.
$300, okay. Multiple controllers, library.
Yeah.
It's a $400 system.
I agree. Sure. I get your point, Chris. I agree 100%. I have no patience for people to talk, oh, Nintendo needs to cater to core gamers. They need to cater to core gamers. You don't sell Wii numbers for core gamers. There ain't that many of them. And they're already embedded in either Xbox, PlayStation, or PC. That's not your market. I'm talking about the general marketplace. I think Matthew, I saw earlier in the chat, Matthew made the point. $199 opens this console up to every living person in the Western industrialized world. If you've got a TV, $200 is a price point for this system. I would buy this launch day for $200. At that price point, it makes it worth it to me to just get it now and play one game. Well, like Vinny said, at $300 plus the game and everything else, it's not there yet. So I'm talking about the general average Joe marketplace. $300 is too much. The games that they are all up their ass about are not general marketplace games. The 1-2 Switch, that fad is done. That was the Wii. It's over. It's gone. It was great. I love it. Hey, like I said, all the credit in the world. I'll probably own the 1-2 Switch at some point. I think my wife wants to play it. And for she and I to play some of those weird two-player games, I'm in. It's not going to move the system. Arms Boxing, they might have a sleeper hit, but it's going to be a very niche sleeper hit. It's not going to be, that's not a killer app. It's not going to move the system. Zelda at this point, I think it's basically No Man's Sky. I think the hype and its delays.
Really?
I mean, don't get wrong. It's going to, don't misunderstand me. It's going to be way better. The reaction to Legend of Zelda is going to be way better than No Man's Sky.
I was going to say, No Man's Sky crashed and burned, right?
Well,
you're talking about the levels of hype.
The hype crash and burn. For everyone that I've talked to who's played No Man's Sky says it's a great game. It doesn't have everything they thought it was going to have, but the core game is exactly what they said it was going to be.
That's what I said, because I played it. It was the hype killed it. Sony took it over and promised all this shit that the developers never said, hey, we were making this game.
It was a Kickstarter game. It was an indie game. Right?
It was like, hey, we were making this game. This game launched. It was our vision. That's what we wanted. It's Sony's fault. They overhyped it. They promised all this shit.
Oh, yeah.
I see that with Breath of the Wild. I think that this system launches March. The next 6 months are going to be very long for Nintendo until Super Mario Odyssey
and
comes out.
And Nintendo, after the Wii U, for whatever reason, you know, some people say the Wii U, in all intents and purposes, as far as numbers goes, was a failure. I know some friends who say the Wii U is this amazing console, which it has its good taste.
I love the Wii U.
Well, it's the, you know, some people say, oh, it's the typical Nintendo thing. They want to blame everyone else, the haters, because Nintendo, whatever. Commercially, it was, it didn't do well.
And let me say real quick, Nintendo, I understand why the Wii U didn't do well. It's the same reason I didn't buy it till 4 months ago. The marketing on it sucked. The game library on it sucked. At the end of its lifespan. There's like 15 games. I'm like, oh my God, I want to play all these. And I bought them all. Now, I haven't played any of them. I'm pointing at they're still in shrink wrap. I haven't touched them. It is, in hindsight, it's a really good library. But not any one of these games is exciting.
Well,
Woolly World, Captain Toad, Mario U, 3D World, Zelda Wind Waker. None of these games are exciting. Taken all together, you're like, oh, these are really good games on this. There's a lot of fun on this system.
Well, my
but
point
I bought it at the end.
My
if
point
I bought
on
the system when it came out, I probably would be livid with the Wii U. If I bought it when it came out, I would be livid because it's taken the entire lifespan to get to here.
Wii U to buy when it came out wasn't even on my radar. I made that point to say because it was all intents and purposes a failure for numbers wise. The fucking Switch had to come out fucking punching, no pun intended, with arms.
Right.
But it had to come out punching. It's coming out of Zelda. They're relying too much on the Zelda fan base and nostalgia to sell the system.
And Zelda has been a known quantity before the Switch was a known quantity. They said a year ago, that Breath of the Wild would be on our next system. That's all we knew. NX.
NX, but, yeah.
Yeah, regardless. We knew it was going to be on the next system. We didn't know anything about it except they're okay, who gives a shit? Okay, and great.
What hurt Zelda is it's going to be on the Wii U, which we mentioned before. So right. Is it that much of a system seller? Because it's not like, oh, I can only get this game on the NX. It's like, if Switch. If I'm looking at the Switch, I'm like, I don't know if I want to buy it. Where are the games? Oh, Zelda. Well, I already own a Wii U. I could play Zelda.
Yeah.
And, so take Zelda out of the equation. Well, what lineup does this make me buy a Switch?
To that point, when I was, and you know, part of it was Chris was streaming it and then restreaming it, and then I was Chromecasting it. So that is a, you know, generational degradation of the signal.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
So it did look better when I watched it this morning. But when I was watching it last night, I thought this game does not look as good as Wind Waker HD. It looked a little bit better this morning when I watched it on my own.
Right.
You know, first generation feed. But Breath of the Wild on the Switch does not look, and probably nor should it, because it was supposed to be a Wii U game that just got delayed to the point that they pushed to the next system.
Yeah.
I don't, again, if you own a Wii U, this game doesn't move a Switch.
It's not like they're, it's not like, it's cell shading, right? I mean, it's not like they're doing individual hairs on the top of GameCube.
It's GameCube technology. It's GameCube technology. Yeah. Remember Beautiful Joe? Remember Beautiful Joe?
I never played that game. No, I don't. I've never saw it.
2D side scroller. So it was during the cell shading hype. There was that fad, like every game was cell shaded, and it was sort of the one that kicked it off because it's just a great little 2D side scrolling beat 'em up, kind of a Mega Man style game. Super nice. Fun, really pretty to look at because it's got these great bright, vibrant cell shaded sprites and colors and everything else. But that was GameCube. And people came in and copied it worse and destroyed, to a large extent, destroyed that medium until Wind Waker came out.
Wind Waker was amazing.
Wind Waker is
amazing. We all agree that.
Yeah. And God, the Wii U port of Wind Waker, because I have it on GameCube, and I played it for probably, well, I don't know. I don't know how long I played it, but I didn't play it very far into the game, and I hated it. I thought it was such a hassle to have to pull up my menu all the time and get the wind, you know, song, or pull up the map and try, where the fuck am I supposed to sail this goddamn boat? I hated the game on the GameCube. To be honest, I don't even, not even sure why I bought it on the Wii. Oh, I know why I bought it on the Wii U, because I knew it was popular and I could stream it. I bought a game that I knew I didn't like.
Yeah,
because I'd stream it and I thought it would do well for my stream. I fucking love the game on Wii U. It's so good because all of your shit is on the gamepad. The map is right there in front of you the whole time.
Nice.
All of the directional buttons you need to know, it's on your pad the whole time, as long as you're playing it on a TV. So it completely changed the way that game is played. Wind Waker HD for Wii U is a million times better than the game on the GameCube. But
on
it's
the
still,
Wii, you mean? You keep saying GameCube.
Yeah, Wind Waker was on the GameCube. Wind Waker's a GameCube game. 100%.
So it got ported to the Wii U.
Mm-hmm. It's Nintendo. They port everything.
Yeah, it's a GameCube.
Oh, that's
game.
Right, because there was all those other Zelda games.
Yeah, the Wii had Twilight Princess.
That's it.
And it had Skyward Sword.
Right. And I don't even know of anyone who played Skyward Sword.
I played it. My buddy owned it. I played it for a minute and I was like, and I'm the wrong person because I don't really love, I love Wind Waker HD. That was super fun. But by and large, I don't like any of the 3D Zelda games. I know, shoot me. I don't like Ocarina of Time and I don't like, Majora's Mask was better. I started playing Majora's Mask for the first time about a month ago, a couple weeks ago. And I played it for a few days and I actually was like, okay, this is markedly better than Ocarina of Time, but I still don't like it.
Well, you guys know this already. I told you guys already. I was going to play Breath of the Wild either somehow, and that will be my first Zelda game.
You've never played the original Zelda?
I've never played any Zelda game.
Oh, the original Zelda's so
good.
I've
told you guys this. I've never played a Zelda game.
I know, but it's still... I realize now you've told me that, but
I can't believe it.
I played... One of the first games I streamed was the original Zelda. I played it from start to finish. Yeah. I had so much fun with that game. It's so good. I can't even imagine what it's like to play it sight unseen, having never played it, because there's so many secrets in it and there's so many hidden things. And the thing about it is, when you had it on the NES, they actually talked about this on the Treehouse event. There's going to be a Master Edition of Breath of the Wild. And I actually went and looked and tried to buy it. It's $130. Comes with the game. Comes with a statue of not the Master Sword, but some other sword. And apparently it's got NFC, like amiibo functionality. So apparently it's going to do something with the game. It comes with like a challenge coin type of.
I know what you're talking about. I sold them.
Yeah. Comes with the a carrying case. Yeah. Oh, it's super cool. It comes with a carrying case that holds your Wii, your Switch. And then it's got slots for like 15 games or something, all this stuff. But what it comes with is a map. And if you had the NES Legend of Zelda, it came with a map and the map, a paper map, and it showed you where those secrets were. I can't even imagine. How would you find those things today?
Oh, I remember in Zelda 1 where I had the candle or whatever. I would light each individual bush on fire. I did that too.
Every single bush. You'd spend hours lighting every bush looking for secrets. Yes. And when you found one, you thought you were gone. Oh, my God. Yes.
But I love that guy. I spent so many hours on that game. That was a
different time, though. You can't do so. The new one comes with a map, which I just thought, like, that, you know, here's to you. That's that. So many games are coming out with deluxe editions today to try to jack up, you know, the MSRP. By and large, I think most of them are bullshit. But I have to admit, this one, I was like, okay, I see you.
that deluxe edition, is it a Wii U available? Is it Switch exclusive?
I think the Master System comes with the Switch version of the game. I think I have not been able to. That's the one they showed, obviously, because it was a Switch event. But when I went to Best Buy and GameStop, they didn't really have any info on it.
The case looks sweet. I love how it had more slots than games that would be available.
It holds way more games than it's future proof. It's future proof. You'll be able to add the games that come out in the future. We didn't talk about the games too much. The rumor was that the games were going to be on SD cards, but they're actually on SD size proprietary cards.
Someone's
going to hack that.
Yes. Well, they might hack it, but what do you have? You're not going to be able to do anything with that. You don't have a Switch card reader to your computer. Like, you're not going to be able to put, like with the Wii, you could do homebrew. Like, Nintendo promoted that. You could hack your Wii, you could mod it, you could do homebrew games. You could download games that other people had made to your Wii. Sorry, no, I think I said Wii U. To the original Wii, excuse me.
I think
the
I
original Wii.
Promoted that?
Not like, they didn't like put it in the press release, but Nintendo wasn't shy about it. They said, this is a thing that people are doing. We're adding this functionality to the system because it was an update. It wasn't there originally. It was an update. We've added this functionality to the system called homebrew. If you want to go through these steps, you can. It's no longer going to brick the system, and you can download games that people have made. However, we're telling you, you know, winky, winky, wink, that you need to download original IP games that are created by fans, not, you know, ROMs and, you know, all that other shit. But I mean, come on, it is what it is. People are downloading ROMs. Yeah. But yeah, they kind of embraced it halfway through the Wii's lifespan. And I think the reason for that was because the Wii game library sucked, and people were making the Wii was really easy, from what I understand, really easy to program for. Super easy. That's why there was so much crap on the system.
Oh, okay.
Really easy to program for. So a lot of fans and programmers were making original games that could play on the Wii, and so they added this functionality. So you could do homebrew, but with the proprietary cards, you're not going to be able to put a game on them because you're not going to have the dev unit to put your game on the card.
Yeah, I didn't even see that, so I didn't know. I didn't learn enough what morning. The difference is. I didn't. I have nothing to say about that. I don't know anything about it.
I mean, there's not much to say about it. It's a slightly different form factor. It looks like an SD card, but the implication, they didn't explicitly state that they are or are not SD cards, but looking at the card, they showed the card, they kind of came in on it. It appeared to be a proprietary system. It kind of makes sense. Who's going to make a non-proprietary cartridge or disc or whatever? Cause even PlayStation, okay, those are all Blu-rays, but they have software on them that makes them proprietary, you know? So,
My question then becomes, you know, with how small the Joy-Cons are and how small these little, you know, proprietary SD cards are, people are going to lose this shit.
Yeah, it's on you.
Probably. Yeah, it's on you.
And then you have to go, you know, pay $70 for a new game, $50 for a new Joy-Con.
No, it's they didn't.
But it's not so different than a disc. You got a disc and it gets scratched, you're fucked. Yeah.
Which yeah, I take good care of my discs, so they don't fucking get scratched. But yeah, kids are gonna lose them. Kids are gonna lose them. Parents are gonna fuck the fuck out. So much.
But I mean, I get yes. I'm gonna say yes, but I'm also gonna say no because Game Boy games were small. They probably got lost, but nobody bitched about it. From what it looked like on $20. Yeah, in 1992 money.
True.
But the DS games, they're basically the same. They're slightly larger than 3DS games cartridges or whatever those are cards. So they're slightly larger than those cards. So I mean, you're right. They are going to get lost, but you know that's the world we live in. We just complained about the batteries not shrinking down fast enough. The reality is that that we can store ridiculous amounts of data on these tiny cards. Why would you have? True. I mean, shit. Even the Nintendo, the Nintendo carts. A lot of that cart is dead space.
Yes. Yeah.
So even in 1985, you know, the actual game was only this big, but the cart was this big. So
yeah, I don't think anyone.
I don't have an issue with that.
I don't think anyone other than you, Chris, might be having issues with. Oh my God, I'm gonna lose.
I'm just bringing shit up. That's all.
No, and that's where we're at. We're at the cleanup mode.
But they didn't go over what I was kind of they didn't really touch on. Again, my biggest problem. This is a conference that should have been at E3, not a month and a half out. What's their policy at with virtual? Are you going to be able to download game? Like, they didn't touch on their virtual console, or not even virtual console as old games. I'm talking about just like, can I buy the game digitally off the console, or do I have to buy the hard copy of it? Like.
Not touch on that, but again, to me, that falls under ubiquitous. You can on the Wii U buy the digital game if you want, and you can download it, and they have the SD cards that have an infinite expandable memory essentially. So I don't have a problem with them not touching on that because I think it's kind of a given at this point. They did virtual console with the Wii. They did virtual console plus digital download on the Wii U. I don't think you have to call that out. I think that's a given.
Do you think it's probably not worth the time or the money, but like, can you make your own cartridges in a sense? Like if you're buying something virtually, can you just buy like a, whatever, 2 gigabyte card, put it in, save the game, download the game to that one card and just play it off there if it saves and then pop it out. And then when you want to play the other game, you pop the other game you have downloaded on that card in.
Sure. I mean, that's what people do, right?
Yeah, I think that's actually the intention to a certain extent.
I'm going to have one card. If I forget, I'm going to have one large gigabyte card. I'm not going to make different cards for different games. But I just thought that crossed my mind. I can make my own.
I think that's assumed. It's like it's same with the touchscreen. I think that's assumed at this point. And I don't think they need to call to it. And I think with the Japanese conference, that's clearly something that we think about that would not fall under their umbrella for what they want to talk about. I'm sorry,
I don't want to cut you off. I just thought about this. Like, maybe I'm just brain farting. My brain's not working right. If I was to download, say, I popped in a thing, I bought the game digitally, I downloaded it, it's saved to that card. I popped that card out, I put a new card in. That doesn't register that game's on the system. Couldn't I just download it again and now have two copies of the same game?
You'd probably have to buy it again.
But say I lose my card. Say I lose my save data, and say I lose my card, and I could buy a new memory stick. I want to get my game that I paid for already. I'm gonna have to buy it again because I lost my memory stick.
That has to like be an issue with the Wii U. So I wonder how they deal with it.
I've never tried it. I've never used an SD card with the Wii U. I have no idea. It's just a save data. On the Wii U, doesn't it just do save data? Maybe that's all it does on the Switch. We're assuming that you can download games to those cartridges or to those SD cards.
I hope so. If Zelda's going to take up fucking 13 gigs.
Oh, it's not because I'm going to get it for the Wii U. Which actually brings me to a point I started to make, but we got sidetracked watching the third generation stream on Chris's channel and how I thought it didn't look that good. The Switch, and let me preface this because my argument is, look, for my entire life, the argument has been that Nintendo's graphics aren't good, right? Because the Genesis looked better than the Super Nintendo, the PlayStation looked better than the 64, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So I have been fighting for 20, 30 years about the fact that graphics are not the end-all, be-all, and it's all about the games. However, Everything we saw of the Switch looks like the Wii U. It does not appear to be graphically
worse.
Better. In some cases, worse.
Yeah, no. you're not looking at those videos and saying, "Oh, this is so much better than the Wii U." It's just different.
No, that
you... and to the point that some games, not even about looking better, because again, graphics aren't everything, and I compliment Nintendo because their games typically stand the test of time because they don't try to push the graphical envelope. But some games looked bad by today's standards. Breath of the Wild was one of those games. There were moments where I'm watching the Breath of the Wild trailer and I'm like, that looks like some PS2 shit.
No, you kind of hit it on the head where a lot of people, the Nintendo defense, which I get, Nintendo doesn't try to be a graphic powerhouse. That's not their thing. It's about the gameplay and all that stuff. But you still kind of got to, even if you're going to play 5 years behind, you still kind of got to keep moving. You know, if you're going to play, if you're going to play 2011, when the next year comes, I want my games 2012. You know what I mean? Just,
yeah.
You're right. Yeah, some of them, and I agree with you. The Zelda did look have some parts where I was like, I could see that being played on.
I didn't like the way the grass looked. I didn't think the grass looked that
as an example. Well, and I remember reading people talk, you know, to Vinny's point, but last summer when they showed the teaser trailer and people were like, oh, the game looks like shit and there's all this factoring and there's all this clipping, and I was like, I didn't see any of that, and I didn't. And I went back and watched that E3 trailer or whatever it was. I guess it wasn't E3. It was Nintendo Direct, whatever it was. But I went and watched that original teaser trailer multiple times. I'm like, the game, I mean, it doesn't look like PS4, but it looks smooth. It looks clean. It looks good.
Sure.
But when they, but these things that they showed in the last 2 days or last 36 hours at this point, I started seeing those things that people were talking about that I couldn't see before.
That Nintendo Direct is probably so touched up.
You sure it's just not poor quality recording or you know what I mean? Like,
even, maybe, but I didn't see that with the arms display. I didn't see it with the Mario Kart 8 video this morning. You know, I didn't see it there. Could be the stream, because they did have stream problems. They had a lot of stream problems this morning. This morning, the stream was really not good. They were fighting the whole time. Yeah. I felt for them so bad as someone who has a litany of streaming problems. I was like, you're going to get torn apart over this, and it's bullshit, because anyone who's tried to stream knows that you're keeping like 1,000 balls in the air and praying to the Lord above, whichever one you might subscribe to or not, they don't all fall down. So like, I gave them a pass, but so it could be stream related. That's possible, but I didn't see it consistently. And even in the Breath of the Wild trailer, it wasn't consistent in that one video. There were, like you say, the grass looked weird. Some of the shit in the distance looked weird. Some of the transitions when a character turns around looked weird, you know? So there were these small things that on a game of, to me, Breath of the Wild Switch should be the equivalent upgrade over the Wii U as Wind Waker HD is over the GameCube, or Twilight Princess HD is over the Wii. It should look better than it does on the Wii U, and it looks worse than what I expected to look on the Wii U.
Well, maybe not, because maybe your point is correct, but don't forget, they were late with this game. This was supposed to be a Wii U game. So how long in development was it being built for the Wii U, and then all of a sudden we're going to push it for the Switch?
Oh, years. Years. Yeah. It's been delayed multiple times.
So at that last end, they have to upscale a little bit for the Switch, do a little bit with Switch. How much can you really do when the entire game has been built for the previous console?
Well, but that's my point. So don't upscale. If upscaling it makes it look like shit, then don't.
So essentially, when you really think about it...
Because I don't have a problem with the graphics on the Wii U. They're cartoonish. That's Nintendo. That's what I buy in. That's what I've bought buy a Nintendo console. You know, so make it look like I said, Wind Waker. Wind Waker HD looks beautiful by and large.
No. Well, yeah. Well, what the problem is, people acting like it's a Switch game. It's not. It's a Wii U game. It's being ported to the Switch. Basically, sure, yeah. It's being ported to the Switch.
True. But it doesn't look as good as the Mario Kart port.
Maybe that was, you know, started a lot later in development, you know, as far as the Switch. You know what I mean?
It doesn't look better than Mario Kart on the Wii U, though.
Mario Kart's a much smaller game in scale compared to
I get Zelda. That. I understand that there it's not apples to apples, but
it's like as beautiful as Grand Theft Auto looks, it's not going to be a graphic powerhouse because it's a lot more in it.
It should be better. Like it should, you know.
If the system can't handle what they wanted to do, they needed to do something different.
Is there any video on side by side comparison of the Switch versus the Wii U version?
I don't know. I haven't seen it, but
I'm gonna be curious about
that. I don't know that anybody's seen it, but yeah, there will be March 3rd. There will be.
I'm gonna be curious about that. Is it 1-to-1 identical or is it slightly upscaled? I'm gonna be very curious about that.
If it's 1-to-1 identical, then that means the Wii U version doesn't look good either, and I'm very disappointed in the result of that game.
Well, that would just solidify my point as Zelda shouldn't be a system console. Like people think it is, it's going to be. But when you really look deep at it, it shouldn't be. If you own a Wii U already, it shouldn't be.
A system mover. It should be a system mover.
I wonder, when is the Wii U version going to be released?
I would think the same day, right?
I think so.
That is a mistake.
If the Wii U version gets delayed further, oh, Lord. And I'm not a huge Zelda fan, so it doesn't really make or break for me. But
if you want to move consoles, you don't give the game to the older console.
I agree with what you're saying, but Breath of the Wild is a case study because it was supposed to be out like a year ago on the Wii U. Longer than that now. By the time the Switch comes out, it'll be like 2 years delayed on the Wii U. They have pre-orders sold. They've got, sure. I mean, just consumer goodwill. You have to move that game on the Wii U. You have to. That Breath of the Wild, not specifically Breath of the Wild, but a Zelda game was announced at the launch of the Wii U. We're making a new Zelda game. It's going to be the greatest thing you've ever seen.
Oh, wow. It's been that long, huh?
Yes. So now we're at the end, literally the death spell of the system, and you're not even there yet.
Yeah. That's why it's I don't know. What else do I really say about it? It's all smoke and mirrors on Nintendo's part with the Zelda game.
Yeah.
Is there any?
You have any more points there, Banks?
Yeah.
Oh, I have lots of. I have lots of points. Listen, I took a lot of notes because my presumption going when the presentation started is that I was going to have to defend vigorously Nintendo's good name. To Vinny. So I took a lot of notes, and after a while I realized my notes weren't positive.
You act like I was going in ready to just I wanted to hate and I was just gonna bash.
I don't think you went in wanting to hate Nintendo, but I do think you went in expecting that to battle with me for the show. I think that's conflict, controversy creates cash, conflict creates interest. So I think to a certain extent there was that expectation that you and I were going to battle on this.
The funny part is my expectations were low. So
that's true.
I only wanted. So Nintendo was just going to blow. My thing was my expectation were low. Nintendo's about to blow me away. I'm going to be so hyped. I'm going to talk the fuck out of this console. I'm going to pre-order. Yeah. I'm going to buy it day one. They didn't meet my expectations.
No. No, and that's true. I will say this. I had conversations with Vinny, like offline without Mr. Kristopher present, about the Switch. And I think to a certain extent, Vinny wanted to be moved to pre-order this system. He was talking about a couple days ago getting up and going to pre-order the Switch. He wanted to be impressed.
I've been thinking about ways on how I can manipulate money together, scrap money together. Yes. I have two gift cards I'm sitting on for $150. I was going to put them right on it.
This has been huge conversation. So I don't want to mischaracterize Vinny's position. He was absolutely wanting to be enticed to buy the system. For me, because I said 9 months ago, before we even started doing the show, that this was going to be a day one buy because I fucked up not buying the Wii U. I saw my delay on the Wii U as a mistake, and I still kind of feel that way. I should have bought it sooner than I did by about a year. I probably should have bought it a year sooner than I did. So I was going in like, I'm not making that mistake again. I'm day one-ing this thing. some of this is going to be repeat, but obviously we've covered the cost. The cost is a deal breaker for me. I am cautiously optimistic about the smart device connectivity. I want to see how that plays out. I think there's some opportunity there.
Yeah.
I think to the Super Mario Maker point, if your tablet can connect with your system, you could do Super Mario Maker on a TV that way, because you could have all the editing on your tablet in an app form. So I think there's potential there. And I think that whereas a year ago, we would have said, ain't never going to fucking happen with Nintendo, but with Pokemon Go and Super Mario Run and their commitment to make iOS games going forward, there's maybe some potential there. The online thing is a huge question mark. Positives, the region unlocked, I think is a big deal. I think getting rid of region locking is should be an assumption in 2017. There's so many games over the years that never made it to the US for no reason whatsoever than somebody in a suit on either side of the pond decided that it wasn't going to sell. So now you have the option. You, as a consumer, have 100% freedom. You can get whatever game you want anywhere in the world. I think that's a good thing. Touchscreen, again, ubiquitous, should be assumed. It's now confirmed. Battery life is a huge problem if you're going to take a mobile. I don't intend to take it mobile, and I do like that they sort of countermanded that by having the portable, so to speak, charging option. You don't have to dock it to charge it. You have the sort of external charging functionality. One thing we didn't talk about that I think is very cool, but I don't think will be utilized, is the 8-player local multiplayer. You can have up to 8 people, 8 switches playing on a wireless LAN setup. I think that's very cool.
Very cool. Dog and pony show. When are you ever going to be with 8 fucking people out somewhere playing your
Switch? I think, yeah, who has friends like that in real life?
Yeah.
Lots of people. Lots of gamers do. Lots of hardcore gamers take their entire computer tower. They take their Xbox, they take their PlayStation, and they do these LANs. I understand that it's sort of passe with the capability of online, but these things still happen. They still have these parties because, yeah, you can play online, but it's still more fun to have a huge party where everybody's together and you order 50 pizzas and you get a keg of beer and you get a bunch of booze and you fuck around and you play games and you know, there's whatever assholes in a band's playing music in the corner. It's probably Mr. Christopher with a shitty cover band. I couldn't resist.
Puddle of Mud.
You know, Puddle of Mud, Jars of Clay. That environment still exists. So I think that is very cool. And it harkens to what I understand, because I haven't done it firsthand, but with the DS, they had a functionality where if one person had Mario Kart 7, you could wireless with your friends and they didn't have to have the game.
What?
And they didn't have to have the DLC. I think it was stair step. They either didn't have to have the game or they could all have the game, but they didn't all have to have the DLC. And you could still all play the same courses with Mario Kart 7. And that was the thing that everybody sort of bragged about. I was like, that's really cool. That's very fan service oriented. It's still not 2017 because it's built on this premise of all of us getting together, but I respect it for what it is. I think that the 8-person local multiplayer over Wi-Fi is very cool. And if the system takes off and sells very well, particularly in places where mass transit is the way you get around, New York subways, things like that.
Sure.
You're going to be able to, because you don't have cell signal or Wi-Fi signal on a subway generally, right? Because you're underground. But a couple people on the subway, they all got their switches with them, and they can sync up and do the thing. I just think that's cool. I'm probably never going to use it, but I like that it exists.
Well, yeah,
in theory.
I'm just going to get on public transit with the freaking basically $400 worth of...
In New York City?
Everybody does every fucking day.
In New York City? No, your ass is going to... If there's one thing you know from being around this part of the area, you don't take your phone out. If you have headphones, they don't show what you're attached into. You don't take out any gaming device on a fucking New York subway. You just don't do it. You don't know.
Okay, valid point. That was just an example that came to mind.
Point number two, why that's not going to work, other than in theory, the fucking thing's going to be dead by the time you get to the subway.
Well, you make a valid point.
Well, you don't turn it on until you get there, but that's... Yeah, battery life, definitely.
Yeah, we touched on the Joy-Con colors. You know, it's kind of cool.
Those look cool. Yeah, I like the colors too.
I would like them. I would like them to go as far as Xbox did, where you can custom build your controller. You know, it's just like Nikes. You can go online. You can order custom Nikes, custom Xbox controller. I think it'd be cool if they did that.
There's a third party website that you can do that. I wonder if they're going to be doing that with the Switch.
Yeah, things. I don't know. I would like to see it. Proprietary or not proprietary, but first party. We've touched on it, but we haven't talked about it. I have two big problems besides cost with the system. Okay. Based on what they showed us in the last 2 days, I see, contrary to the image they want to put forth, I see limited third party support.
Yeah.
And I also see limited first party support right now with this system.
Well, yeah, overall games. Which they don't have the games. Third party support, like they always do. Oh, we have 80 different companies. What games are they making? They're making some.
How many of those games get canceled in development? And how many of them are one and done, like throwaway sports games? I don't need 2K18 on my fucking system or whatever.
Not even sports games. They're just these small little. It might be a small little fucking game like Bejeweled that's fucking coming out. You know, just don't say what type of games they are.
What was it? Puyo Puyo. Well, yeah, Puyo Puyo Tetris, which is an amalgamation of two games that are huge in Japan that only sort of made it to the U.S. And that was not a marquee title. They didn't specifically play it, but they showed it a couple times on the Treehouse event this morning. And then it goes back to my point at the very beginning. It's all SNES. It's Super Bomberman. It's Ultra Street Fighter. It's Sonic Mania. It's Dragon Quest 10 and 11, Heroes 1 and 2, Project Octopath, Minecraft. I mean, you know, Minecraft.
Well, you know
Minecraft
what
today looks like an N64 game, so what's that?
You know what the problem might be? I just thought about it. Because the overall stereotypical, the Nintendo fan, the fanboy, isn't getting the other consoles. Maybe they don't know, like, newer games exist. Maybe they think that those are the only games out there anymore.
No, yeah. I'm gonna call bullshit on that because I think that even Nintendo customers are Nintendo customers and they're also video game customers, so they probably own more than one. Minecraft, I mean, it's the only game bigger than Minecraft. At least over time is probably fucking Angry Birds. Yeah. There's nobody that hasn't played the goddamn game.
I've never played Minecraft. Mario Brothers. I'm proud to say I've never played Minecraft, but I know what it is, obviously.
Well, you've seen it though. You're not, you know what it is. It is a known quantity. There's nobody, there's nobody excited for Minecraft on the Switch.
No.
Okay. There's somebody saying, oh, I've waited all this time to play it. It's finally coming to Nintendo.
Just like
you could play it on a PC from 15 years ago.
Yeah. Just like Skyrim, just like 2K. You know what it is? If Nintendo, I gave up on the point saying that I want a system. Remember, my whole thing was I wish Nintendo would come out with a system just as powerful as the PS4, but it has Mario on it. I would buy that in a second, blah, blah, blah. I had given up on that. It's not going to happen. That's not what they want to do. It's fine. It's fine. Nintendo's their thing. But at the same time, no one's buying. Because you don't have a system as powerful as the other ones, why are you going to buy fucking 2K, Skyrim, your thing? Why you would play on PC or if you're going to play that, or if you own an Xbox, you're going to play on Xbox over Nintendo.
See, I never played Skyrim. So to be honest, before you guys said anything, I thought, oh, well, maybe this is something I should try now.
But why would you wait for it to come out? Because they don't even have a launch date. Why would you wait for it to come out on Switch instead of just buying it right now on your PC?
Because
I don't really care about it.
Well, if you don't care about it, then you're not buying it.
And
you're not buying it for $60 on the Switch then. You might buy it 5 years from now when it's $20. So that's a missed starter.
You'll buy it for $60 on the Switch while it looks three times as good on the computer for half the price.
Right. So, I mean, here, let me make sure I got all these. Hold on. I missed one. Hold on. I'm making a list as we speak because I want to make sure I catch all these. Sure, we'll give him credit for that.
Is your list Brothers. have the new Mario game on Odyssey?
Yeah, we talked about Odyssey, didn't we?
No.
So let's talk about
we went through the games list like when we started.
We talked about we touched on it. We didn't talk about it. We touched on it.
Well, I don't know how in depth we wanted to get. It doesn't come out to the fucking holiday.
It doesn't come out to holiday. I think Odyssey speaks for itself. It looks amazing. Odyssey looks super cool. I want to play the fuck out of Odyssey. I mean, they did right. They took and they used this tagline. I actually thought this when I saw the Odyssey trailer last night. I had this thought. They enumerated this thought this morning on the Treehouse event. They took all the best things from Mario Brothers, Mario World, Sunshine, Galaxy 64. They took pieces from all those games and they put them into Odyssey. The game looks so much fun. It looks crazy good. Okay, it looks. You know what? They kind of fucked themselves by delaying Zelda. Maybe Mario should be the launch title. That Mario Odyssey is probably a killer app. It probably moves almost. In fact, it almost assuredly moves, and I think that's why they're waiting till holiday to release it. It probably moves the system. But let's run down the list. Okay, you've got Mario Odyssey. I don't think there's any debate by anybody that that game looks super awesome fun, right? Yeah, it looks ridiculous.
That's the system stuff.
Done. Okay, you've got a Zelda game from the last generation. It's from the last generation. There's no Metroid game, no Donkey Kong, no Smash, no Kirby, no Mario Party. I'm even going to get in credit for New Super Mario Brothers, which is the 2D side-scrolling franchise. No Yoshi game. So now, they have two of their IP franchises, and one of them is from last generation.
Now, just playing devil's advocate.
Where's the Nintendo games?
Not that it's smart for them to do, but you think they just didn't release them yet? I mean, announce them yet?
Oh, I'm sure they're going to make them. I think they should have talked about them.
They should have said, hey, look, this is coming out sometime.
They should have said, even as simple to the extent of what I just did, to the extent of naming off all of their immediately recognized, they could have just named a list of all of the Nintendo properties and said, you guys love, because it would have generated buzz in people's minds. Yeah. People would have gotten excited. Start naming off the franchises, start naming off the characters. You guys love these. Remember how much fun you have with all these characters? Yeah. We're going to bring them to you all new, brand spanking new on the Switch. Portable at home, wherever you want to go, you're going to be able to play all these things you love. Coming soon. All you had say, they said fuck all on it. The Japanese event was like an hour long. The Treehouse event was almost 5 hours long this morning, and I watched almost all of it. You remember the direct last summer? We all complained about it. It was 2 days, and all I talked about was Breath of the Wild. And all I did was show the same running a circle over a hill. And then the next day was all Pokemon. The second day was all Pokemon. They didn't talk about anything besides those two games for 2 days. The Treehouse event this morning was barely better than that. They did ARMS for 45 minutes. They did Snipper something or other. Snipper Clips, which is the puzzle game. They did that for what felt like forever. They did the Super Street Fighter thing from Capcom. They spent like an hour on that game. It's Street Fighter 2 Turbo. There's nobody alive who gives a shit who hasn't seen it. They spent an hour on it.
I tapped out at 12, man. I wanted to go stream. I'm like, I'm out. I can't do
it. I have the privilege of being on the West Coast, so I had extra time to watch it. And I still tapped out. To Vinny's point, I tapped out 40 minutes after he did it because I was like, fuck it, I'm going to go watch Vinny stream. It was more interesting to me to go watch Vinny stream than it was to watch the Switch event.
Yeah, it was. I think basically we can keep running around in circles with the same thing. Yeah. I think what the thing is, I don't think any of us are actually pissed about the fucking, besides the price point aside, the actual system.
Price point's bullshit. No.
Actual system. I think we're fine with the system. I think all of us are fine with the system.
There's nothing to it.
You do not release a console after a commercial failure with no games. And when you do release the games, you're going to give me games that came out 15 years ago and you're going to put a $40 price tag on the motherfucker. You do not do that. Again, Zelda, which is, we can say it over and over again, Zelda's a port. It's a Wii U game that they're porting over at launch.
Yeah.
ARMS is a new IP. It looked like it'd be fun for a week. I don't think you're going to get longevity of it. Mario Kart port, Splatoon 2 in the summer. The games that are launched are just shitty little games.
Yep. I wanted Nintendo to silence the haters. I needed them to do that for me today.
I wanted to be silenced.
Not only did they not, but they motivated me to criticize them. Because even when the Wii came out, it didn't have that many games, but I could still go, oh, well, that's different. That's kind of cool. It's not for me, but I like it. I like that they did that. And then, of course, over time, games came out, and I'm like, oh, shit, I need to go get a Wii. You know, I don't have any of that now. There's nothing about the system. The system's fine. The system, to me, is, I don't want to say irrelevant, but I'm not taking, other than, like Vinny said earlier, other than to my couch or my bed, I'm not taking that system portable. I'm not going anywhere with the Switch. It's just, it's not the way I game. I don't even like carrying my cell phone around because it's so damn big. And it's got plenty of games that I can play when I have 2 minutes waiting for at the doctor's office. I don't need a full system. I need, you know, solitaire. Okay. You know what I mean? Yeah. So the system to me is fine. It is what it is. There's nothing special about it.
So I have a question then. Couldn't the Switch just be peripherals that you bought for a Wii U?
I think so.
And just, I mean,
I thought the Wii U was peripherals for the Wii. That's why I didn't buy it for so long.
Yeah.
Their marketing on it was terrible.
I mean, you just buy the new controllers and it's the same, you know, it's the same process. Well, not the same processing, but it might as well be from what we've seen so far.
If you really break this down, could you envision yourself walking around? Like, I don't know what your day-to-day life is, but mine, if I'm leaving the house, I'm not, like Banks said, I'm not carrying that thing with me. And if I, like, when are you having time to play it? Like, are you bringing it to a friend's house and playing it? Like, unless if they have one, yes. If they don't, wouldn't that be kind of rude to just go to your friend's house and start playing the fucking thing?
I don't think the average adult, there's going to be people who are going to say, I'm going to play it on my commute. You know, like I carpool and da-da-da-da.
We're looking again, at it.
To me, that's what your phone is for, because your phone has a hell of a lot longer battery life. And you can charge, if you like carpool to work, chances are you go to an office and you can charge your phone through your work computer, and you may or may not be able to do that with the Switch. So are you going to carry the charging cable and the you know, brick that goes into the wall? Are you going to take that with you? I don't know that you're going to do that.
In your briefcase, your little briefcase.
I don't think the average adult is going to play the game on the go. I think, I mean, God, remember I think we made this comment when we talked about the teaser trailer. Ain't no one at the courts in Brooklyn playing 2K17. Your shit's getting jacked.
Yeah, that
ain't happening. And then the hot chick with the Super Mario, what turned out to be Mario Odyssey, but in the trailer looked way like a completely different game. You're not going to a rooftop party and bringing your Switch, because you're going over there with vodka. And if you're going over there with anything else, you're getting thrown out of that fucking rooftop party.
Yeah.
It's not adult oriented. Okay, so it's for kids. You can't trust the kid. The reason the DS works is because it's clamshell. It closes tight. You can't trust a kid with a flat open. That shit's getting broken.
I'll be dirty as a motherfucker.
That shit's getting broken tomorrow. And it ain't like, it's not like a cell phone where you can just replace the glass. There's not going to be anybody replacing the glass on the Switches anytime soon, if ever. If that glass is proprietary, and it very well may be, no one's going to be able to replace it, and you're going to be fucked. People are complaining now about the fact that they can't replace their Wii U gamepad. You can't buy those separately. They only come with the system. You cannot.
You can
repair it.
I didn't know that.
Not first party. You can't buy it first party.
There's a third party?
Well, like used and refurbished and things like that.
Oh, okay. I was going to say.
Yeah. I mean, look, yeah, they exist, but I'm saying you can't buy a brand new pad from Nintendo for the Wii U. It was not available. You had to buy a whole console. Oh. So I don't see the mobile part of it being utilized. I think it's a gimmick, and I think it's a bad gimmick. The Wii U motion controls were a gimmick, but it was a good gimmick. It was smart. It got people interested and excited. I don't think portable gaming, a concept that is now 30 plus years old, and B, a concept that has been shrunk down to your phone, I don't think that makes a bit of difference. I think that's a functionality that didn't need to exist there unless you're trying to kill off the DS line.
Is it just not an American thing? Because maybe it'll be in Japan.
Oh, yes, Chris. Make no mistake. But the Wii U was a huge hit in Japan. I think the Switch will be a huge hit in Japan. I think Switch the portable gaming will be the portable part of it will be ubiquitous in Japan, because that's the way their culture works. Japan is it's a bubble, and I don't care how many systems they sell there. It ain't as many systems as they could sell outside of there.
Sure.
Yeah.
And I think that's Nintendo's biggest problem right now. They're looking at sales numbers and going, oh, look how many systems Japan bought compared to everybody else. We need to cater to Japan, but you're looking at the baseline graph. You're not looking at the potential. You're not looking at the sales you did not make in Europe, in America. Yeah. Hell, the developing world is very quickly becoming bigger than the developed world. And they're in a position now where they could potentially buy these products.
I think you hit it the nail on the head there with they're so bubbled with Japan. They care to Japan first, and as long as Japan sells well, that's all they care about. I can't see, as just the way I do mobile gaming or all that stuff, I couldn't see carrying around that.
It's too big.
It's beautiful.
You have to carry. You have to have a shoulder hatchel.
You need a whole case.
Man purse.
All right.
It's.
So we can go on forever with this. We can start recircling points. Is there any one big point you wanted to make before I ask you guys the final question? We hit on a lot of shit.
I know for a fact I will own the Switch at some point.
Okay, well
buy the Switch. I definitely want to play Odyssey. That game looks badass. There's a presumption there's going to be a Smash Brothers. I don't know why there wouldn't be. I made the point that they didn't announce any of those other IPs. A lot of those IPs are going to make it to the system. It will happen at some point. Okay. And I like the SNES. I love the SNES. So even those games that I shit on today, I want those games. I just don't think that they're system overs. I don't think they're marquee games. So I will own the Switch at some point in the future. It will absolutely, without question, happen. Nintendo, to Vinny's point earlier, needed to come out this week swinging for the fences, and they don't even have a ground rule double, to make a baseball analogy.
Chris has no idea what the fuck you're talking about.
No, because he doesn't know. They needed a factory chicken farm, and they don't even have a dozen eggs.
Wow, okay. I get that one.
That's well, for you, sir. Banks kind of Thanks on the answer to that question. Chris.
Sure.
We all probably know, everyone, if you listen this far, you kind of know what we're going to say anyway, but fuck it. Let's get a final definition here.
Yeah.
No.
Wait, okay. Hold on. Hold on, motherfucker. I'm going to ask you. Are you going to pre-order? If not, are you going to own it? If so, when do you think you're going to own it, or are you not going to own it at all?
My turn?
Yeah. That's my question.
No, because I want to say something. I think that anyone pre-ordering the system is up for a big disappointment. I don't think there's going to be enough units to fulfill pre-orders. I think pre-orders are going to grossly outpace supply.
Okay, Chris.
I have another point to make. I'm just kidding.
No, it's, you know, like a month ago, people asked me, you know, I told them, I'm like, I'm going to be a day one Switch buyer. And now after all these, you know, valid points that I find are valid, have been made, I'm like, well, I don't see the reason to be a day one person, because I can get that Zelda game on my Wii U that I already own.
Do you own any other games for your Wii U? Oh, you do. Oh, it's Vinny that only owns two games.
Yeah, Paper Mario, Mario 64, Super Smash, Metroid M.
You're lagging like a motherfucker, so we can't see what you're saying.
20 minutes into this game.
That game is terrible, and, unfortunately.
I've never played this game. I'm sure it's great.
I heard it's really good.
Yeah, I liked it. I got it for the PlayStation.
So, anyway, yeah, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 games for the Wii U.
Okay.
So anyways, I was going to be day one buyer. Now I'm not going to be day one buyer because, for one thing, I don't have the money to pre-order it right now. Yeah. And I don't really have the desire to go look for it in my couch. You know,
if you had the money, would you pre-order it? If money was not a factor, would you pre-order it?
If I wasn't a streamer, that would be 100% no.
Okay, fair enough. We talked about streaming. We were like, oh, yeah, we have to get it. We're streamers. We have to get the system. And now we're like, but not really.
I'm not seeing any games that I want to stream. Like,
everyone's going to stream Zelda. Everybody. So what's the point?
I'm not going to stick out. You know, I'm an amazingly entertaining person, but I don't, I, I, that, that game doesn't appeal to me like as much. I don't want to be a part of that crowd. So I will eventually own it, I'm sure. But they need, like, you know, Bangs, you've been saying, they really need a title that's going to pull me in.
Yeah. Did you own the, you did not own the original Wii, or you did?
I've owned every single Nintendo home console there is.
Okay.
And the only non-Nintendo console I ever had was the Xbox 360. And I thought that was a great console. Like, I love the games on there. Red Dead Redemption,
360 was good.
Loved it. Loved it.
And I screwed up. I bought the OG Xbox. And then I wish I had bought the 360, except that I probably would have had the Red Ring of Death issue, because I would have been a first gen. But I was just curious. So you had the Wii. So how many games do you have for the original Wii? And the reputation of the Wii is that it's all garbage, that it's all shovelware, right? So how many games do you own for the Wii?
I don't own my Wii anymore. I either sold it or gave it away to somebody who would have appreciated it.
Well, how many did you own?
How many did I own? Wow, that was a long time ago. I probably just as many as I own for the Wii U.
Five or six.
Yeah.
See, around that area. I just counted. I have 15 games for the Wii U, most of them in shrink wrap because I've only played like 3 of them. I probably own 20 or 30 games for the Wii. I probably have about the same for the GameCube. And at this point, I probably have the same amount for the for the 360. But to be honest, a lot of those have been picked up in the last year or so.
Yeah, you get a lot of the bargain bins.
Yeah, well, bargain bins are just because, like, I was streaming and it's like, oh, I remember renting that game. I should go get that. You know what I mean? Because in those days, you didn't necessarily buy every game. You rented it. Sometimes you'd rent it 4 or 5 times.
Yes.
Because it was so much fun, but you didn't necessarily buy every game back then.
Blockbuster, days of Blockbuster.
There you go. My heart is breaking because there's nothing. Mario Odyssey doesn't come out for at least, let's say it comes out in October. Let's just be generous, because they didn't say, they said holidays. But let's say it comes out in October or November leading up to Christmas, right?
What if it gets delayed?
Oh, fuck. I don't want to talk about that. That's a hypothetical.
It's very plausible.
Super plausible. Although I will say this, I believe that Odyssey is finished. I think they're sitting on it purposely.
A fucking year? I don't think they're sitting on
that
year.
That sucks. That would suck.
I think it's done. Or it's like as close, or it's, you know, it's either done or so close to done that they could put it out this summer. I think that it's probably more or less done. So Odyssey doesn't come out for 8 months. That's the one game that I want. I mean, I would play Project Octopath. I would play that Street Fighter game. And I definitely was interested in Sonic Mania, but according to Vinny, that's not an exclusive game, so never mind, because I already own a PlayStation. When do I need to buy this system? There's nothing on the system.
Bangs, you've already had your turn.
we're beating dead horses now. It's getting a little tedious.
I know, but I'm the Nintendo fanboy. I'm the most heartbroken over here. There's nothing for me here.
We're going in circles now. We're trying to end the show.
All right.
So Chris said eventually he'll get it. I think all of us eventually are going to get it. Here's the thing, like you guys were saying, I wanted Nintendo to tell me, hey, we're going to show you this and you're going to go buy it day one. I was figuring out ways how I could scrap money together. So the point you made earlier, Bangs, if you have the money, mm-hmm. Like my buddy John, it's already pre-ordered. He has a game and another Joy-Con. He makes great money. It's his thing, you know. He could do it. Right. If I have the extra money and I know eventually I'm going to get one anyway, I'll just get it for launch and I'll play what's for it. Like Chris's point, I'm not scrapping together pennies to try to get this thing.
Right.
And we are ready, and the price point is huge because we, like we touched at the beginning of the show,
it's too expensive.
It's not a $299 console. You buy a game, you buy whatever. We're under a shade of $500 for one game system. That's where we're at, $500.
Yeah.
Pre-order, obviously not. Well, pre-order is going to be tough to get now if you didn't pre-order right away. So no, day one, no. First few months, no. I'm looking at if I have the money in like summer, maybe. Or right before holiday to beat that holiday rush. So, you know, y'all fighting with everyone. So eventually, yeah, I'll own it. But like, to everyone's point, and we're all beating the same horse, it's the games. I think we're all fine with the console. The prices are ridiculous. $70 for a pro controller is they're fucking high.
Prices are outrageous. They're unacceptable.
Right? Yeah, and even the even some of the games that they're porting, I'm not spending. I don't want to spend $60 for fucking Mario Kart 8 again.
Well, and we talked about on our first show, because we at that time were presuming the system was going to be about $250. We figured the Pro Controller was going to be $50. That brings it to $300. The system is $50 more than we expected. The Pro Controller is $20 more than we expected. So there's a $70 jump. That's more than one game in those price points.
And you're talking Pro Controller. Say you don't even want the Pro Controller, but you want to get another joystick so you can play with people.
So it's $80. More than that.
It's even more money.
And I think the extra Joy-Con controllers are, if you're buying the system, I think the extra controllers are a given. When I watching the Treehouse, it didn't even occur to me that you could do extra Joy-Cons. The Treehouse event this morning, when they talked about it, I was like, oh, I didn't even think about that. That's a good idea. I'm going to need those. And now I see they're $80. $80 is a lot of money. It's you can do a lot of things with $80.
I want to point out Super B-Rad in chat. He's a good guy. He comes a lot to our show. He's a real good guy. He, I say this with respect. From reading what he was saying, he seems like your prototypical blind-eye Nintendo fan that I was talking about. But he makes a point. Remember, the original Wii wasn't widely available in stores for until almost 18 months after launch. It was sold out everywhere for close to 2 years. That's true. The Switch is going to be nowhere near that. It's going to be nowhere near as popular as the Wii U.
6 months.
I mean, the Wii. And I don't think the Wii, did the Wii launch it? Didn't we talk about this? It launched at, what, 250?
Didn't launch at I think it launched at 250, but it didn't stay at that price for long. And it came with the game.
You know, it wasn't selling controllers.
It's a small game. I get it. But it came with a game. It came with something.
And that game was huge. Remember, the Wii blew up. It wasn't really much for the games. It was the parents, the old people. They loved it, and all they wanted was the Wii Sports.
Sports game.
They want the Sports game.
Wii Sports is like, and I don't know the exact numbers, but it's something like the best-selling game of all time because it came bundled with the Wii.
You can make the argument that Wii Sports is the reason that Wii sold as well, because we made that point. We made that point down the line. As successful as we made the point earlier, as successful the Wii was, it fucking dropped in sales.
Yeah. Yes, it did drop in sales, and yes, its reputation in hindsight isn't great, but when you sell that many consoles up front, of course it's going to plummet in sales because not that many people have to buy it.
Agreed. Sure. But if the Xbox and 360 and the PS3 just met those numbers fold behind, yes, Xbox 360 and PS3 blew past. At the end, everyone thinks the Wii, greatest selling console of all time. But the PS3 sold more consoles than the Wii. Like, the Xbox and PS3 end up going past the Wii.
I mean, just for the sake of accuracy, I've seen those numbers. I think that's in the U.S. I believe the worldwide, US. The Wii is still the best-selling console of all time. Worldwide.
U.S. makes sense. It makes sense. Yeah. That makes sense.
I believe I've seen those numbers. I believe that's U.S. But let's be honest, that's what we're talking about. You know, outside of the U.S. is outside the U.S. I had a broader point to make, and I forgot what it was now about the Wii. For as much crap as the Wii gets for shovelware, it also had a really good games library. You had two Super Mario games on that system, Galaxy 1 and 2. And those are great games. Galaxy 1 and 2 are phenomenal games. And you had two Zelda games on that system, even though one of them was the same kind of thing. It was GameCube / Wii because it got delayed so long. So you had two Zelda games on the Wii. You had a Donkey Kong Country inspired game on the Wii. You had Mario Kart.
We haven't seen Donkey Kong Country in a while, have we?
They had what's it called? Tropical Freeze on the Wii U. Freeze. It's in shrink wrap. Okay. I haven't played it yet. But it's exactly like Donkey Kong Country Returns for the Wii.
Yeah.
Again, great game. A phenomenal game. I mean, it's Donkey Kong Country. It's a sequel to a 2D side-scrolling game, but it's a great game. It's super fun to play. Donkey Kong Country Returns is an amazing game. But so my point is that we had a very good, strong game library buried under a bunch of garbage. Not only do those games not exist right now for the Wii U, for the Switch, they didn't even talk about them. They didn't even mention them. They didn't even suggest them.
Yeah.
Look what we can do with this boxing game. That's all we did.
And that was your point. That's what I'm talking. That's what we're talking about. Coming out punching. Maybe the games aren't even in development. Announced that they're going to be on the system.
Yeah, and that's you have a plan. We have a plan. We have a story. We haven't started development, but we have an idea.
Yeah.
Nothing.
They
to Vinny's point, the Japanese event should have been at E3 last year because that's all it was. It was pomp and circumstance. It was nothing of substance. The Treehouse event this morning was a hell of a lot more substance, but the downside of that is it showed us that they don't have a whole lot of substance to show because they spent way too much time on very niche.
They showed an hour of fucking Street Fighter and they all HD graphics. It didn't look, it was a coat of paint. It's the exact same fucking game. It's not even Street Fighter 5. 20 years ago. No.
It's not even Street Fighter 5.
And
that game's a year old.
Your blind-eyed Nintendo fanboys. Oh, I can't. It's so exciting. Oh, my God. I'm going to. It's the same fucking game you played a million times. They get over it, and they're going to charge $40 for it.
That Street Fighter. Yeah, exactly. That's the point I was going to make. That Street Fighter game is at best, a $10 virtual console download. At best. And it's a $40 marquee title from Capcom. Fuck off. That's bullshit. All
right. Well, we're just keeping it getting worked up. We set out things. We said positives. A few, a lot of negatives. It was more disappointment, though.
I agree. It really was. It's just a matter of disappointment.
Which I think, you know what it is? I think we're pissed about our biggest thing, not to speak for you guys, is the lack of games. But we know the games are coming. We hope.
Do we?
But yeah, I think we do. The price point. You know what's funny? We don't have a problem with that fucking console itself. It's the price. Hmm.
It's everything around
the
console.
When we say price point, we're not talking the $299 base price. We're talking about if you really want the system, it's costing you a shade under $500.
It's the same reason I didn't buy the PS4 at launch because it launched at like $400, and then so it's like $700 out the door by the time you're all done. But when it gets down to being $300, well, now it's like $500 out the door. It's still a lot, but now those games are $20. And that's another thing to keep in mind. Nintendo's games almost, until they become Nintendo Selects, they don't go on sale. So those $60 price points stay at $60 until almost the end of the system's lifespan. So like when I bought my PS4, I walked out of Best Buy with a PS4, 2 years of PS Plus, and like four games that I paid $20, $30 a piece for.
Yeah, you could do that. And it's...
You don't have that with Nintendo. The Wii U's dead. And I can't get like right.
Mario Kart's still fucking $50.
Oh, yeah, it's still $50 on a good day. I was just looking at Best Buy. It's $60. Pokken Tournament, $60. Splatoon, $60. Super Mario Maker, $60. What's it called? The Twilight Princess HD is $50. Because you know it's a HD update from a last gen game, but it comes with a amiibo. $50.
You know why?
And that's on sale. It's $60 MSRP.
And this is that. And we keep what we're angry about is we were hoping that Nintendo would bounce back and do all this stuff. They're gonna sell. Here's the reality of it. They're gonna meet their quotas in Japan. They're gonna be happy about it. They're gonna exceed their quotas. Yeah. They're gonna do okay. If you own a Wii U, eventually you're probably gonna end up getting. If you're a Nintendo fan at all, you're eventually gonna end up getting the system. This is the problem. And Nintendo probably gonna be happy about that, which is the fucked up part. What gets me angry, they're not grabbing fans back with this system.
They're hoping to latch onto that Wii, the original Wii crowd. They're hoping to latch onto the retirement.
That's
homes.
What they but they're also coming in at
not for
an
that
easy,
money.
Yeah, they're easy. No. Yeah, an extra $150 no. bucks easy. $150 bucks
not
easy
for that money.
On top of that. Exactly. No. So they're not bringing back fans that from other systems or anything, and it's and what we talked about, well, I'll say it again because we talked about it fucking 2 hours ago. You're coming in midlife through the PS4, Xbox One, about 5 years in, 4 or 5 years in. So you're coming in the middle of that. You got to do a reasonable price. I know you're a new launch system, But you're coming in at $299, no game included, accessories, $20 higher than the accessories for those systems, and your hardware doesn't even match theirs. So you want to come in at $299 when, if I'm a gamer, I don't own any console yet, like I made the same point before, what am I getting? The brand new Switch that's under not as powerful as the other one, no games, I'm going to have to buy the accessories, maybe I can play Zelda. I can go buy an Xbox One for $250 bundled with Battlefield 1 and has a repertoire of games I could buy for $5. PS4 bundled with Uncharted 4 or something like that for $300. Yep. And a bundle of games. Accessories that are $40 cheaper.
I think the only,
you're not capturing the only
way, no, the only way they move the system beyond the initial launch hype, which is going to be, as we talked about, will be limited quantities, are people that, it's going to be like Gen Xers, people that were in college during the 64 and didn't have time for the Wii and the Wii U, and now they're, you know, they got kids and they're, you know, they're sort of at that age and they've got, you know, more time, so to speak. You might grab some of them back for the console.
If they can survive.
I don't think they walk away impressed. And I think that I think it's like the Wii. They buy up the console at the beginning and they don't buy another, they don't spend another dime.
If they could survive the first year, they might. This is the shame of it. PlayStation 3 launched overpriced. Remember, $600.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
had,
yeah.
No, way had, overpriced. Had no... I bought that motherfucker at $600. Had no games on it. Same, very... kind of, like, similar. Now, it's not $600, but... You know why it was $600, though? It had a Blu-ray, you know, it had a Blu-ray player. It was before Blu-ray players were a thing.
It was top-of-the-line technology.
Yeah.
The Navy runs off of PS3s wired together. It was cheaper to buy a bunch of PS3s than it was to build a supercomputer.
Yeah,
so the government systems are running off of PS3s right now.
It was overpriced without, you know, it was not overpriced for the hardware, but for a console, it was overpriced. Had no games. They survived, though, the first couple. It was rough for them the first year or two. Remember, mm-hmm. Xbox 360
was a failure.
Crushing. It was a failure.
Mm-hmm.
They pulled away. They pulled back, and they ended up going and selling, I got 83 million consoles.
And that is the one upside to doing hardware the way that PlayStation and Xbox does compared to Nintendo. When you're on the cutting edge gets cheaper with time. And so over time, you're able to reduce that price point. But when you're, but that's only because you launch at a cutting edge with a higher price. So people go, oh, it's only $300 now. Such a better deal compared to the $600 when it launched. Or it's only $200 now. Such a better deal when it was $600. I'm going to go ahead and buy it because the cost of the internals gets cheaper over time. Nintendo being 5 years ago, always, those are already as cheap as they're going to get. So it's not going to get cheaper to build that system.
But they're giving us a price system point doesn't match the PS3.
Correct.
At $300.
Correct.
When a PS3 is like $120, you can go buy a GameStop.
It should be as powerful as the PS3 and arguably as powerful as the launch PS4.
Launch PS4 powerful? No, that's more powerful than the Xbox One. I don't know if it
the should launch have been... PS4?
Well, yeah, it doesn't get...
Okay, fine. Okay, it should be as powerful as the Xbox One.
It should have been as powerful whichever. As the Xbox One.
Fair enough.
But it's not as powerful as the 360 or PS3, so what are we making an argument about?
Right. We don't
100% know if it's not as powerful because, again, console's out coming out a month and a half. They didn't release that fucking internal specs yet, so we don't know yet.
Well, based on what we saw, it did not appear to meet that standard.
They kind of confirmed that it's not going to match, you know, PS4, Xbox One, but we're anticipating 360, PS3 range.
I don't know. It's kind of sad that it seems like they sacrificed that to make it mobile.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and not even cheaper. Like, if you told me, like we said, we made this point a couple times already. You told me, all right, this is $200, $250. Even with this game's lineup, the accessories were $40 to $50. Yeah, fine. I'm a first week buyer. Why not? Yep. That's what I want. Not at this price point. That's our argument, I think. The game, lack of games, and the price point. That's our problem. And knowing Nintendo, it's not coming down anytime soon.
Right. It's priced in line with better with more powerful systems. With a larger game library, and it doesn't have either of those two metrics. So It's like we said, the first thing right out of the gate, we said it's not priced for the marketplace.
Yeah.
It's sad. It's disappointing. And it's not coming down to points in the chat. The Wii U today, right now, is still $300. It comes with Mario Maker. That's it. Or it comes with Mario Kart. There's a Mario Kart 8 version of it. That's it.
You know what I love too? You're also getting, I know Nintendo doesn't need it because the games are lighter, but you only get 32 gigabytes of hard drive or space. Now, this one you could change, but even the Wii U's point, you got 32 gigs.
These new consoles, second version of it.
Yeah.
The second version of it.
I understand the games are much bigger for the console. You have to install them, but you're still getting 500 to a terabyte. So if you're paying the same price, where's that money? My thing is, where's the money? Like, I'm paying $300. What is costing that much
and
money?
Even the 500 gigabyte isn't enough because I don't know anybody owning a PS4 or an Xbox One, that, and myself included, and I'm not a huge gamer on that system, who hasn't gone in and replaced it with a bigger hard drive. And I replaced mine. Just from the PS Plus download, because I never bought a digital game had not bought a digital game off of PlayStation. Just the free download games within a year, and not even keeping all of them, I had to replace the hard drive because 500 gigs wasn't enough.
No, you know, see, that comes with 500 gigs. So in a way, okay, I'm spending $300. I'm spending $300 for the PS4. You kind of know that $30 of that is for that 500 gigabyte hard drive.
Yeah.
You know, if you're buying at the store, it's like 50, 60 bucks. But you know, they're spending whatever.
Yeah.
So
now for the sake of accuracy, I will say this: part of the reason those systems need that is because optical drives don't read as fast as a SD card drive will, so they can keep more of that data on the Switch card. They don't need to put it on the hard drive because it can read fast enough off that digital card than you can read it off a CD. So there is some science behind that, but the point still remains.
Yeah, it doesn't change the Wii U only having 32.
Right. Yeah, the Wii U it launched with 16 gigabytes, and it wasn't even large enough to handle the there was an update for Smash 4. Smash 4 redid the Wii U. They had the Smash 4, I don't know the specifics, but apparently Smash 4 launched either launched broken, or they had planned so much DLC for it that the original Wii U could not handle it. Its hard drive was not big enough, so they had to release the 32 gigabyte version. You know, fuck you to everybody that bought the original Wii U, but...
Yeah. All right, guys. This has been a longest show to date. I don't think, is there any more? We could just keep bashing the same points over and over again. We're in the point where we're recycling stuff. Is there anything new at all that you want to say that we won't touch on down the line? I think we're all in agreement.
I think we covered it. I think
we covered it. We're all in agreement.
Did I mention that there's going to be a mid-generation upgrade? There will be.
Oh, geez.
Yeah, you mentioned.
Okay.
I could see that.
That was my last one. There will be.
Eventually,
double the battery life in 2 years.
Here's the bullet points: lack of games, way overpriced. None of us, we have no problems with the actual console itself, but eventually we'll end up getting one. Eventually,
yep.
So it's not like oh, we're not getting it.
When the library catches up, then it's a buy.
And I have faith that the library is gonna get there.
It probably will.
It probably will. You know what it is? I think we're pissed about. Why didn't you announce these games? Or why is it they're more at launch? It's not the fact that they're not coming. It's that. Why aren't you saying anything?
Yeah.
Guys, if you came in late, I ask you, feel free to rewatch in VOD. Don't forget the podcast will be up. If you're listening to this
show,
it was a passionate show. If you're listening to this, thank you for listening this long. Guys, like we say every week, don't forget to subscribe on iTunes and Google Play. Give us a review and a star rating. We don't know how it works, but it helps us. We don't know how Apple
algorithms are a bitch.
Yep, we don't know how they work theirs. We'll be back again next week, Friday, 9 p.m.
Eastern,
6 Pacific, 7 wherever the fuck Chris is.
Yeah, don't worry about me.
Well, until daylight savings time, which is right around the corner, because we now roll the. Well, yeah, because they changed it. This is completely off topic, but they changed the daylight savings time like 10 years ago. So now those of us that observe it, we fall back in November and we skip forward in March. And it used to be 6 months. It used to be like October to April, but they moved it on either end. So now we're actually daylight time for like three quarters of the year, or two thirds of the year. So in March, we're going to be, I'll be on the same time as Mr. Kristopher.
That's
by the
fine
time,
with me.
By the time the I'll Switch launches, it. We'll be on the same time.
I'll allow it.
All right, cool. Guys. Fun show. I'm exhausted. It's like 12:30 here, if I may. I am fucking exhausted. We talked a lot. We stepped on Chris all show like we normally do. And
I tried to get him to do Bean Hype. I was trying to plug his stream, but he didn't want to do it.
You did not. I put
it in the chat. I did exclamation mark Bean Hype because Chris has a registered trademark on eating jelly beans on stream. That's a fact that I just made.
Not
up.
On this stream. You gotta come visit my stream.
Do you guys wanna speaking of your stream, do you wanna promote anything for your week or whatnot before we get out of here, Chris?
twitch.tv/MrKristopher and on Twitter and everywhere else. So come visit me. And not only do I play Super Mario Maker, but I also play a few other games like Hex and Faster Than Light. And I will be expanding.
I love how
Super Mario Maker kind of dies down.
Those are my favorite streams of yours.
Thank you.
I'm starting to get, I love Faster Than Light, watching you play that. And I've started to kind of get interested in Hex. It's kind of fun watching you guys. As you've started to figure the game out, it's become more interesting.
I love Mark just berating him.
Yeah, that's fun too.
That's pretty much all I watch.
Yeah, your friend Mark. Yeah, but you know what? He doesn't do that as much anymore because Chris is getting good.
Yeah.
So there's a lot less for Mark to berate him over. But yes, that was
remarkable.
A piece of it in the beginning.
Remarkable_gaming is where I do some Tuesday streaming with Mark.
Good stuff.
Bangs, what can we expect from you?
Twitch.
Good stuff.
Yep. twitch.tv/BangsMichael. My stream machine, my computer died officially last week. So we've gone back. Speaking of Nintendo fanboy, we're back on old, well, what I guess now is old school games. We're playing Super Paper Mario for the Wii right now. And we're going to finish that next couple days. Then we're going to be playing Super Mario Galaxy 2 because we beat Galaxy 1 on stream a few months ago. And I promised to play the second one. And then I started playing Mario Maker and I didn't play another Wii game for like 6 months. So that's that. Follow me on Twitter, please. @HeelBangs, @HeelBangs. That's my personal Twitter account. It's not just promoting when I go live on Twitch. In fact, I usually forget to tweet that I've gone live on Twitch. It's actually all my personal stuff. So we talk wrestling and politics and life and everything else. I also want to encourage everybody to check out the website, bangindonuts.com. There you can find information about all three of us, links to iTunes and Google Play, as Vinny mentioned earlier, as well as links to our YouTube channels. Both Vinny and I put this show up on our YouTube channels. Chris does not because he's a scrub, but you can actually watch the replay on YouTube. And I think that's as good, as much as I encourage you to download and subscribe on iTunes and Google Play. Vinny and I disagree. He prefers the podcast. He thinks the podcast is funnier, but I actually want to push people towards watching the show because I think that there's a piece that's lost on audio. Like for instance, Chris dancing. And also I talk with my hands. So I'm constantly like poof, 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 at the camera for better or worse. So I encourage you to watch the show on replay if you can't watch live.
Well, they both have,
yes, covered everything.
They both have their perks, right? None of them have their downs. They're both perfect, but they all have their different perks. The video, you get to see the visual clues. It's all fun. The audio, I find a little bit funnier because you don't know. When you're watching, you kind of tell when someone's about to speak, but when the audio, you don't know who the fuck's going to say something next, and all of a sudden a zinger comes out, and it's fucking good. Anyway, you can find me. Go ahead, Chris.
No, I was going to say, you know, even if you don't like iTunes, I have, I'm an Android guy. I got a Galaxy S6. There's this app you could do, it's called Beyond Pod, and you could download, you know, Bangin' Donuts on there too. You don't have to be an Apple guy.
True.
So check that out.
Yeah, you can. The podcast is RSS, so you can get that anywhere. I think there's a link on the website. If there's not, feel free to shoot me a private message on Twitter. Yeah, but I'm not sure if there is for the non Google Play and non iTunes RSS. I'm not 100% off the top of my head. But if there isn't, feel free to shoot me a message directly on Twitch, on Discord, or on Twitter, and I'd be happy to get you the link if you need it for a third party RSS feed. Not a problem. And I'm on all three of those platforms basically 24 hours a day, so I can get that to you anytime.
Okay.
And fuck VidiStream. No, I'm just kidding.
No, I'm just... Anyway, you can find me right here, twitch.tv, VidiBadJones. I'll keep this short because we've rambled a long time. Hope you enjoyed the show. Guys, have a great night. We're doing a lot of Ark on my channel now, I think. I played that today. I'm enjoying it. I think we're going to explore that a lot next week. So we'll be doing that. Come by, say hello. Guys, leave. Don't forget to like, subscribe, all that good shit. Leave a comment. Let us know, since this is a broad topic. Yes. Let us know what you guys think the Switch. What you guys are going to order it. You agree with our points, disagree with our points. You want to tell us to go fuck ourselves or whatever you want to do. Guys, thanks for hanging out with us. I enjoyed myself. We all enjoyed ourselves. For Mr. Christopher, Banks, Michael, myself, have a great weekend and good night.